We need more episodes.
My podcast,
Here you go. There's your chance.
Peace.
Let's go. Everybody, it's party time.
The devil is real.
The devil is alive.
The devil is a person, and he is not.
The devil is alive.
I was listening
to telling the truth.
I was listening to a Philly rapper today, and he kept speaking about worshiping the devil. And I was listening. I'm like, he keeps saying
that's
this.
Why everything 666.
No, he was saying like I pray to so and so. It's the nigga Skrilla.
Oh,
and I'm like,
yeah.
I'm not. I fuck with his music, but I'm not really into the.
He does artistry well. But if it's that type of artistry, that's kind of crazy.
I just don't want to ride around listening to that. I feel like some things you listen to could, you know what I'm saying? Like, it puts you in a mood. Yeah. And I fuck with the rap, but I'm like, he's saying like demons' names and shit. And I'm just like,
what's a demon's name?
He said pray to somebody. And I'm assuming it's like some 666 shit.
Yeah. What if it's like I pray to like, pray to Keisha? Like, yeah. What if a demon's name was like Keisha?
Demons probably have crazy names.
Demons probably got
Jamal
like,
is definitely one.
What if it was like Paul?
Leroy.
Like regular names. Yeah,
like Jerry. Jerry,
like Scott.
Hey, Jerry, you going out to the world today? Scott, I'm tired. I worked all day yesterday. I got seven souls, Scott.
Sarah.
She'd be a bitch.
Your demon's name is Sarah.
Sarah be a bitch as a demon.
Yeah. Karen. Y'all believe in ghosts?
Karen, yes. I do believe in ghosts.
I believe in ghosts, too.
But do I?
All right. Do you think there's good ghosts or bad ghosts?
I think there's
all types
spirit
of ghosts.
Is ghost.
There's
spirit
there's
is good.
There's gay ghost.
Okay.
And there's street ghost.
Just two?
There's
what about the transsexual ghost?
They didn't get there yet. They didn't reach there.
Excuse me?
The ghost ain't get there yet.
Okay.
Yeah. Is it because they just started?
Ghosts
are
no,
ghosts
they just
new, yeah.
No.
Ghosts are brand new.
I'm so tired.
They probably came out in like the
so they have to buffer for your, for the LGBTQA plus.
No, we started. You guys, they started with one. And then
okay.
And the rest came.
So like lesbian ghosts.
Yes, they ain't get. They just started to touch that.
So might be careful.
What they got? There we go. No, I do believe in ghosts. I also believe in. Bro said no name coming up. Who is
hey,
this?
Bro, it was white what? Fingernails. I'm telling. I swear to
no
you, don't
name.
Say nothing.
Put
don't say nothing.
Put
oh,
the
yeah.
Cash app,
brother.
Send it to me.
Brother.
Sherlock Homegirl.
That's not weird, yo.
I'm gonna call after this. I'm gonna be like, yo, don't ever call my phone again.
You
because I'm not one
like,
of them.
I'm scared.
Yeah, I am scared. You scared me yesterday.
You scare me. Stop.
Don't ever call my phone again. Yeah.
No, I would see the thing about we was talking about before we started recording was picking up a random FaceTime, and I would do that if I didn't know the number because I would have to know.
I gotta
I'm
know.
Comfortable with somebody enough for you to feel like you can do that. And
my
why the
FOMO
fuck
is gonna kick in.
Yeah, whoa.
The fear of missing out.
I like that one.
It's like an acronym. Fear of missing out.
But your fear of missing out got you some fingers.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't. I would answer that. What if you?
Everybody's
answer
gonna
you
answer that.
Participate in yourself.
Who doesn't pick up a FaceTime call? You what? You gotta know who's calling you. You could see my face.
That's not okay. Let's speak on a double standard.
All right.
If a woman calls you.
Yeah.
Just masturbating. And you don't have her number saved. You don't know who the fuck this is.
Yeah.
That's weird because, you know, especially because, you know, that's weird on either end. Niggas, you shouldn't be doing that either. Don't call nobody. Because
if a guy did
call
it.
Call with his dick out.
Yeah, if a guy did it, it would be crazy.
It's crazy. You feel
but
me?
But if
now
a woman does it,
off.
It's spontaneous.
We're laughing it off.
You rubbing that thing.
Yeah.
Whoa. If a guy does it, a girl going to be like, gross. Get the fuck. No, don't do that.
Somebody might have called you from a text-free number or some shit. Like
somebody, if a girl called you and she was rubbing her pussy, what would you say?
I would bang.
You hang up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I don't know who it is. First of all, that's not how you greet someone on the telephone.
Is
you
it?
Don't greet me vagina first.
It's called this episode called
hard.
Vagina First.
Y'all are
right there now.
That's
kind
of hard. I
yeah, no,
lie.
You greet me vagina
I ain't
first.
Lie.
Now. I just say it like that.
I ain't gonna lie.
I'm the only wholesome person here.
Pussy
let's start
out.
With that.
Hey, clit to the sky.
Is
to
it
the,
someone? Jesus God.
Clit to the skizzy.
To the fucking skizzy.
Yeah. Put your head out. Yeah. Hood
no,
back.
you should have just started like getting your shit off.
No.
What?
No.
That's what they wanted though.
Yeah, probably.
That'd be the
yeah.
So they can screen record you and then post the shit.
Or they just
is
wanted to have somebody watch them.
Is that gaslighting? Playing with your pussy first so you could see.
No. Yeah.
I feel like that is a little bit.
That is gaslighting.
I feel like we're. I
you don't like,
we
gaslighting
are,
anymore.
I feel like we are running that word into the ground.
I know. I seen you tweet. What's going on
yeah,
with that? Who gaslit you this week?
Nobody gaslit me.
You just started seeing that word?
I think that, what made me talk about gaslighting? Oh, yeah, I had a thought about it because I was like,
you had to be fresh off a gaslight.
I had a bit of an argument with the woman that I'm dealing with. We had a bit of a tiff, a bit of a disagreement.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
did you feel gaslit in the situation?
Right.
That happens a lot though.
So what happened was
this might be a text at.
What made me
Might be a text at.
But go ahead. What happened was what?
So basically we were going back and forth, and then that's when I was like thinking to myself, like, I can't even tell her that she's wrong because now I'm gaslighting. And then it just made me go down a bigger rabbit hole. Cause I'm like, if I'd like say that like she bugging, or if I'd
which sometimes be the case.
If I disvalue her feelings, or if I say that like whatever, is that not a word?
No, you keep going.
If I say that her feelings are not valid, then I'm gaslighting.
What is they valid like salad?
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
No matter what you do, you can't even.
Yes, keep going.
Because it's gaslighting. Gaslighting is always going to be gaslit.
So is the gas if the gaslighting accuser actually the gaslighter?
Yes.
Gotta be.
That's what I'm saying, because you started the shit, so that way I can't even start the shit.
Right.
You lit the pilot before I could even throw the flame on there. I can't even throw the flame on there because you started it.
Yeah. So if a nigga really can't say too much shit back.
That's what I'm saying.
You gotta just kinda
let
some shit roll. Because you can't be like, a nigga like me would be like, I respect everything you're saying, but I really don't feel like it's that deep. And apparently
and now you gaslighting. Because
sometimes shit don't be that deep. Why is it that deep? Is it that deep?
But it's that deep to her.
Yes. But not yes. To and me. You know what? And
so
I
what?
Agree.
It doesn't matter.
It is that deep to her, which is fine. But my whole point about it is I can't even say to her, like, you know what? It's not that big of a deal. Even though I understand it is
a
big of a deal to
you.
You
can if you want to be an asshole.
Yeah. You can't, though. You can't say it. Because it's gaslighting.
But sometimes shit don't be that big of a deal.
Then keep that shit to your motherfucking self.
You still can't say it. Yeah, you still can't say it. Because if you go to her and she was just like, well, I was just sucking dick, it's not that big of a deal, you're going to be like, that's a pretty big of a deal.
That's a little bit of a different vibe that you're going with, though. That's a pretty big of a deal.
You were dicky, literally.
No, but Shirty sucks some dick and say, honestly, it wasn't that big of a deal.
You're
overreacting, seriously.
You're going to hit the ceiling, bro.
That's a great one. That's a good one.
She just sucked my dick. It wasn't that. You going what?
I could pull that one.
I don't think anybody.
All she did was suck my dick. Like it was.
I don't think anybody.
I ain't really fucker.
I don't think anybody could. Can you? You can't walk. You can't walk away with that, right? You
can't walk down the dick suck.
You can't walk out the room safe with that.
Not with me, because I'm gonna lay hands on you.
Getting your dick sucked. What if you just said, "I just ate her pussy"?
That's real regular shit. That's a real regular bad.
That's bad, right?
I ain't get on my knees.
It's bad. I'm agreeing. It's bad. Yes.
I ain't get on my knees and do it though.
Yeah.
I kept it real, like, stoic. I ate her pussy real angry. I didn't really want to eat it.
If you were on your knees, where were you?
Oh, my stomach.
Belly on the bed. Yep.
That's nigga the thumbnail. Doing
Naruto, how about we screenshot that? That's like he likes to screenshot eat. My random faces.
Yes.
No, you make sounds.
Me?
No, Lionel.
Not too much. Lionel. I had one bad episode, and they will not stop bringing it up.
Some motherfucking noises.
He said, "Smash, you take that test again, your mama."
Yeah.
No, you be making sounds.
I don't make sounds.
Oh, let's review our last episode. It was really good.
Yeah,
shout
we had
to
an
Chris
episode.
Cavallari.
Chris Cavallari. Make sure you go check that out.
Yeah, it was good.
Go watch it. It's out on like YouTubers. Yeah, I like her. She's nice.
No, I'm talking
about
the numbers. Also like her a lot.
She's a good vibe.
I was like, yeah. Just, yeah.
And a vibe.
She was sitting here and just melted into the sheet. Just
talking. Yeah.
Just like, let's do this.
She's a good talker.
We were supposed to have somebody else tonight.
You don't have to do that.
That's just how
I
about
care, I don't care. We supposed to have somebody tonight, and we supposed to have somebody else another time.
Yeah.
This is why we are not guest reliant. This is just my every time something like this happens with guests, I'm very happy that we don't rely on.
And you know what happens?
Every
week. The bigger you get as far as whatever your profession is,
right,
the more you can't rely on people to be there on time.
That's
now the guest that we had tonight, it was not his fault. It was not on him at all.
That's a fact.
Not at all. Not on him. That's not who we're talking about. We're talking about somebody else at some point in time.
Time.
Because we care about
and him. Not a specific time. Nope. It's just in general.
But I'm just saying, the more
something in your beard.
You grow in value,
in the back part. There you go.
How long is it going to take for you to just tell me direct, like pinpoint it? I want you to drop a pin.
You need some adversity. Nigga said drop a pin on where it was in my beard. Yo, I did an episode with Chris, and I
had never even told me if I got on?
It. Brother, I said you got it. I bet
you. He said I got it.
Yeah.
Why would you let me sit there and keep looking like a dickhead and pull it out?
I did.
All right.
The last episode, if you look at the YouTube, there's a tire mark on my jeans.
Oh, yeah, it was there.
It was a fucking tire.
She said, I like this outfit, though. I said, what? It's a mark on his jeans. I couldn't say nothing, though, because now I'm hating.
No. You should have told me.
I saw the mark.
Right then and there? Yeah, I can't tell him right then and there.
So what happened was, I parked with my car tires out. I don't do that in general. I did.
Yeah.
And when I got here, I must have rubbed across the fucking tire.
Yeah.
Because I'm looking at the clips, and I'm like, I thought it was a shadow.
That's exactly where I saw. I was like, is it a design?
No, it was a
designer jeans.
Are they acid washed?
Never that.
What?
Never acid washed.
I thought they were acid washed.
They were design jeans.
No, they were Foreman Mills.
Design jeans.
Foreman Mills got them type of shit.
They were denim tears.
Yeah.
Right? So they have like little marks on their jeans and stuff.
No, that was a denim tire mark. And I'm like, damn, I'm like a dickhead.
You ever see the mark that look like this?
No.
Good one, Lionel.
I got you?
Yeah.
I'm immune to that now.
That's because I got on like three times in one day.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Dickhead.
I won't even look no more. It could be something. You could show me you made $1 million.
I wouldn't care, huh?
Like, that's what?
If you're sure to come in the room, like, baby, come look at this. You like, yup, yep. I heard, I see you. That's cool. Like, I'm bleeding.
And like, yeah, I'm sure.
Yep.
Remember that night we went to, we was downtown and you was throwing up and I cut my finger.
We was in Northern Liberties. We was a hot mess that night.
That's when we was, damn, we was drinking.
We was
heavy.
A hot mess.
Damn.
We were a hot mess that night.
I slipped my finger on a peanut can.
Yeah.
And Lionel drunk too much. This nigga was throwing up.
Yeah, I
did. I'm trying to go see this nigga. I got blood flowing out my finger.
I said, I'm not
going to
make it.
We still went out.
Y'all went.
No,
not
we
me.
Did. No, you was in the car.
I stayed in the car. You Mike,
car.
And Dev went.
The
three musketeers. I stayed in the car like this.
Seat back.
I said, y'all go without me. I was done. I was done to the world.
Yo, we created some memories down in that area. We created some hella.
Hella memories. Would you rather be drunk for 5 hours straight or high for 12 hours straight?
Oh, my God.
High for 12. How high,
though?
It's
a long time.
Brother, you're high, brother.
As fuck?
You're high.
I don't want to be high for a long time. I'm drunk.
Drunk for 5 hours?
Yeah.
Get it out the way.
Yeah,
because sometimes I'll be drunk for
5 hours.
Throw up. Sleep.
Yeah. 5 hours, though? You just like, this is what, stop.
I don't want to be at my peak highness at 12 hours straight.
12 hours?
I want to stop.
Long time.
I want to stop
that's
at some point.
That's a long time.
Cause at my drunk point, like I can still, I don't know. I know I'm drunk. When I'm high, I'm just like, I'm doing too much.
You overthink when you're high.
Yeah, I'm definitely like, this is not.
Yeah.
12 hours? That's like when we took them fucking Eddies. Now that was a 2 day high.
That
for
was
you.
2 days.
I was 12 hours high. You feel me?
Where
we
you?
Gotta do it. Yeah, fucking right.
Yeah.
I could have got fucked up that night. I could have got shot. I was just walking around West Philly.
All right. Well.
I was walking around Cobbs Creek.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's a dangerous
what time?
Area,
like
bro?
12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning. I just walked
bit
around.
By a cougar out there.
that
live animal.
That might be worse than getting shot, getting by, bit by
a
raccoon.
Bear.
That's
what I'm encountering with a bear.
That's an irrational fear of mine is getting caught in a close proximity with one of them,
like a bear,
possums or
like
a raccoon.
Oh my god, yeah,
that's not bad.
What?
I just feel like there's a lot more like aggressive animals.
I don't think nothing's more aggressive than a raccoon.
There's a raccoon that's
been living its
life on my patio.
Right? Or am I thinking about possums?
Possum.
What did you say?
There's a raccoon that's been living his life on my patio.
Oh, nah, nope.
So now I'm scared to take my dog out because I think he's plotting my
Jesus.
Dog.
No.
Ew. You got to kill it. Your dog got to defend your honor. Your dog has to defend your honor.
Not
going to
do anything.
I mean, you got to go out there.
No, I'm thinking about getting a BB gun. I'm not supposed to say that?
No.
Oh.
You can, but...
You know white people love raccoons.
Fuck
no,
them.
You can shoot
fuck
it.
Fuck the coons and
I just don't trust you
people.
With a BB gun.
You can't shoot a raccoon. Don't shoot a raccoon.
You trust you with a BB gun?
Yeah.
Got it.
You ever been shot with one?
Let's see how you hold it up.
You know what?
You going to get one of the rifles?
Oh, a rifle BB gun is crazy. A rifle BB gun is nuts. You need a rifle hand.
I'm going to shoot it and then...
Bring it in here.
Bring it in. Yeah, hold it by wear the tail. No. That's,
you see this bag right here? I did that.
That's me.
Killed that motherfucker.
No, I'm just going to hold it by the tail. Swing around like this.
Make a hat out of it.
You just got to have it like it's an award.
Make a hat.
Yo, who's going to wear it?
When you shoot it, you got to be like...
Like the young boy. Like the young boy.
That's how you got to... Okay.
You seen them niggas that be on TikTok down south and they like got... The way they grills is made, they made the grill. So it'd be like a... They keep their meat outside in the refrigerator. Like on some southern shit. And they grill be like a file cabinet.
Yes.
It'd be like a smoker and shit like that.
Yes. They keep like different compartments.
Why? I want to be that country, bro.
No, you don't.
No, like, I don't think so.
They seem like they just be having fun. Like drinking.
But it's dumb fun. Here's
the
thing.
I do feel like they be having fun, but it's aimless.
Yeah, it's so pointless. It's like so dumb. Yeah.
It's so pointless. Yeah. Like they be grilling raccoon. You see the guy that...
Oh, yeah. Raccoon.
Like raccoon soup. He was like putting it on his plate with like fucking all of this
that
dumb
shit.
That
shit probably busting.
Nigga said, and the smell. I said, the smell
no,
what?
The smell,
nigga, that shit
exactly.
stinks, nigga.
It don't smell good.
How you gotta lie for
one
me?
One of them niggas picked a snake up and put it on the grill. I said, God damn.
Yeah,
like,
them niggas is different. Nigga cooked the bear.
I fuck with
Did
that.
You see that?
I might fuck with
he
that.
He cooked like bear leg or something like that, bro.
That's
I don't
a big
understand.
Ass fucking joint too.
It was like round.
Yeah.
It was like a big
you
want to
bite a bear
disc? I'm afraid. Pause.
What you
bite a bear joint?
You go ahead and hit
that. you bite
a bear joint?
What?
Yeah.
How?
Pause, nigga.
How?
Because you know joint is
the battery's gonna be out of there.
And we putting new batteries.
I'm gonna replenish.
You want eat bear meat?
Bears.
Whoa!
Okay.
Pause, nigga.
You wouldn't eat like a bear.
A bear meat, bro. You said it already.
You wouldn't eat a bear. Like you wouldn't.
I don't know.
If it was
you
mystery
eat bear?
Meat, yeah. If we went somewhere and they was cooking shit, I would try it.
Oh, I would be free.
I would try.
Cause like, what if it got like rabies? How you test a bear?
Our animals got rabies.
What animals?
The shit we eat fucked up. The bear probably more clear than the fucking, than the turkey.
I'm not letting you start this, bro.
No bullshit.
I'm not letting you get this
Wallahi,
wrong,
bro. Our meat not halal.
It's not prayed over.
It's not
halal.
Not prayed
over.
Not
they don't pray over it.
Yeah.
They just kill it. Probably not.
Them halal.
Yo.
Not there.
No.
All
right. The answer is no.
Free Palestine.
For fuck's sake.
No cata. You mean?
That's a long night.
Come on, brother. That nigga's a dickhead, bro.
He tried beef with me over
there. He tried to rap about it.
Nigga said, y'all niggas all 40. He said, 14 of y'all in one house with no. What'd he say?
I don't know.
He said, all y'all living in that house.
Yeah, he was talking about our beards.
It was just me in the house.
He didn't know that, though.
We got into a beef with a Philly comedian. I did.
Learned it.
Three years ago.
Did we say it?
We don't have to say his name. Like 3 years ago.
I would like to say
that. He did a rap. You can say it.
What's his name?
Rich Dollars.
Not Rich Dollars.
Yeah. He made a rap That's video. A
funny looking fella.
Let's play.
You want to play his rap?
Are you connected?
I could. Yeah, I could connect. Do you have it? You don't even got it, brother.
But you know what I will?
You don't even got it.
I don't even got it, bro.
Brother, find it, brother.
Oh, fuck.
You don't even got it. It's so long ago.
It was a long time
ago. You
should have
pinned it. Like, dickhead, you will forever. You will
no,
forever
I
live.
I was going up a couple times during the pandemic on Twitter.
Yeah.
I was on my Philly. I was trying to go viral on some Philly. You went viral a little bit on the gallery, John.
Yeah, it's just one picture, though.
Yeah, but no, that's you brought up the Yameen nostalgies.
Yeah. Yeah.
But no, I don't feel like playing that shit, but because I can't find it. But he 5 in the morning, he sent his response.
Yeah, he did.
So he woke up.
We were
up.
Waiting.
He woke
a little
up.
Bit.
He woke up.
We was waiting a little bit. Like, it was like a beef a little bit.
It was
like,
because
he said it, and we was just like, damn, this nigga Larry really going up a little bit off of this. Like, Scoop Hall had posted it and shit.
Yo, 5 in the morning. That's why it's 14 of y'all niggas in that one house with y'all struggle bears, and y'all all lit together.
Y'all
nigga,
beers.
It was just me in that house living alone.
He didn't know that, though.
It's on man.
From the video.
Stupid
he
ass
like,
nigga. And he said that from a music video. Why wouldn't we be in the same place in the music video?
I don't know, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Niggas is stupid,
Fuck
brother.
But you know what? That's called having that Philly, you know, Philly vibes. Philly.
He looks, have you seen him? He doesn't look a little. Hey, all right, we are. On, I'm sorry. Somebody probably does know him. They like, yo, Rich, they talking about you. They talking about you, Rich.
Are we believing that?
No, I'm not believing
fuck it.
It.
Okay,
why?
Cool.
He a little funny looking. I don't know.
Okay.
He not? Have you seen him?
I don't even know who the fuck we talking about.
Well, no, if anybody's single on Lionel, I got to fight. So it just is what it is now.
No. It's hilarious. It's hilarious. It's funny. He's a funny looking guy. It's okay.
Halloween, I mean, shit.
You should get him to open up for us at one of the shows.
No. Thanksgiving is coming up.
It is. You ready?
Is this our Thanksgiving episode? Because have an episode out before Thanksgiving?
Merry Thanksgiving, miss.
Merry, yeah. No, we'll be.
What is your favorite Thanksgiving meal?
Hell on a mistletoe.
Yeah.
I'm going to get to know you better.
I'm so confused.
This Chris. I'm Chris Brown. Fireflies and raisin bright.
Solo.
We're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a so special for you and me.
This nigga watched the movie.
Yeah, that's off of Chris Brown. You didn't see that shit?
Yeah, I did.
He was.
You know what it was called?
This Christmas. Yep. With Tiana Taylor.
Trump.
No, Tiana Taylor.
You sure?
No,
absolutely,
Tiana
Taylor.
No, she wasn't.
When she was like, Byron. Nope.
No,
wrong
she
movie.
Wasn't. That's
wrong
Medea's movie. Big Happy Family. That's funny because I literally turned that off to come here.
Did you? Damn. I'm sorry.
You a Medea movie watcher?
You had to did that.
Yeah.
Damn.
Madea got some classes, though. Niggas be trying to front on Madea.
I'll front on Madea.
Why front on Madea?
I'm not the biggest fan of Madea.
I also don't like think pieces in Hollywood where people be like, but motherfuckers had to dress up as a woman to be successful. It's like, yeah. Is that the truth for it? Like, come on, man. Like,
why not just let them live?
Yeah, it don't matter.
Why you gotta eat? Niggas be tweeting that shit from their, like, two-bedroom apartment.
From
their
mama basement.
Niggas like Ari Spears. Like, brother, come on, what are you doing?
Speaking of Ari Spears in the past and things that are irrelevant,
he is funny, a little bit sometimes.
He's funny. Let me shut the fuck up before you flame me, because I got no comebacks for a real comedian.
These two fat motherfuckers.
Yeah, but
that's how you gonna say it. Oh, we got Rosebeck. You ugly, though.
Yeah, you ugly.
You don't get no bitches. That's shit. That's how you lose.
We can't do a money battle with him. He got that.
How you know?
That's a great point.
How do you know?
How do you know?
He's lying.
Niggas be fraud. Remember, no, you don't remember, but a long time ago,
this nigga
look
like somebody tried to draw his face a little bit. I'm telling you, brother.
Is it just a match?
Brother. That nigga is.
Just a match?
Come on. Okay.
Up close screenshot.
Crazy. That's how I gotta get it.
A long time ago, I had a radio show when I got out of college in Philly.
Whoa.
On in Girard. In Girard. And shout out to Lee that let us use her space too. But my quote unquote famous guest was Lil Duval.
Oh, that's fun.
But not in person.
A phone. Phone interview?
We was so excited. We was like, she was like, I got y'all Lil Duval. And we was like, let's go.
Said everybody.
But mind you, you know when niggas do pressers, right? When they just sit in a room and they make all the calls they have to make to radio shows, to all type of shit. He promoting a movie.
Yeah.
So he probably just made 30 calls that day.
Absolutely.
He get to us. This nigga gave us like 7 minutes.
What did he say?
He was just like, what's up? We like, man, we so appreciative to have you. Da-da-da-da-da. That nigga was not trying none of that shit. He was trying to get to the questions. And then when we started getting deeper in the questions, he was like, look, I got to. It'd be hard out.
Yeah, I got hard out.
Give us a solid 7 minutes.
5 minutes.
Yeah. That shit made niggas whole week that week.
Yeah.
For Lil Duval.
Said I talked to Lil Duval.
That's how I was
this
though.
Around when he was doing that, when he had that song?
No, not even before. It was before the
that's
song.
Way before that.
Yeah.
Oh.
This was like 2016.
Oh.
Yeah.
What movie was he promoting?
Some hood shit. It wasn't even like a big movie. It was just some random shit. Because think about it. He's calling a radio station, an internet radio station in Philly.
That's why I'm like, he not in a lot of shit.
And he wasn't popular. So it's like, he just was.
It was Lil Duval though.
It was Lil Duval. And I got on there and I was acting like he inspired me.
You said, wow, because you did a lot.
I was like, man, you so inspirational. Yeah. I was dicky and like.
When we was in New York.
Yeah.
That was hilarious.
At what level are we allowed to dicky?
You can do it all the time. We look at it. It's crazy. Some shit is dicky in.
That's true.
And then some shit is just like, you know, you see somebody love. that you really. But either
like
way,
you
it's going to be
Scotty
dicky,
Beam and
you
didn't say one word?
At all.
Because you real niggas don't dicky.
I can't say nothing. I can't tell her, like, yo, you are absolutely beautiful. And I'm just so glad to be in the same space as you.
Yeah. I love when a young woman looks how she looks, or even better, from Instagram
like
in real life.
And then in real life.
Because it's like.
IRL.
Yeah, because that shit is like, it's a game. It's like a sketchy game. You pull up and you don't know who you getting.
Who do you feel like is like that? Looks the same on the internet than they do in real life.
Just start naming random?
Yeah, like Bria Miles.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I think Sexy Red looks the same.
No.
You think she looks better online than she does in person?
No, I just think she looks different.
I think it's like a scratch and sniff.
Ew, I don't.
Why not? I would love to. I would love to scratch and sniff Sexy Red.
No. That's not the problem. That's just random.
Why not?
A scratch and sniff?
Yeah. You know what that is?
Creeper territory.
It's like you scratch it and you sniff it.
You sniff it.
You wouldn't want to scratch and sniff Sexy Red?
Some people do scratch and sniff in real life.
I won't scratch and sniff. It's crazy.
Some people, they got to, you know. Who I think?
Who do you think would look the same on the internet than they do in real life?
Do you think Joe Budden looks the same on the internet?
No.
No, he probably looks a thousand years old in person.
Yeah, I think he probably looks a little older.
Mm. He looks 1,006.
You think they're editing his shit?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just think he knows his angles by now.
Pause.
Could you go ahead and... Thank you.
Pause, nigga.
Easy. I appreciate I'm you. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
what we got going on there.
That's crazy.
This nigga got smacked in the club. Yo, but
do you think he's too old for that?
He's too old to be going to the club alone at this point, and he's famous.
How famous? I think. Do you think he's as famous as everyone thinks he is?
For sure. He has the number. He has, outside of Joe Rogan and the other probably one or two white.
Yeah.
Humongous podcast. Joe Budden is like, you know what I'm saying?
Fame. Yeah. But here's the thing, though. Like, right. It is just podcasting.
Not necessarily.
Right?
Because it's a TV show now. It's YouTube.
True.
It's not just audio no more.
Yeah,
so.
True.
I mean, but that pod is not his claim to fame. So
it's not, but it's the biggest thing he's ever done. Joe Budden's rap career is very minuscule.
It might be there now.
Oh, for sure.
I think.
But let's not also forget there's a small gap of people who only know him from like his Love & Hip Hop. Punch.
Oh, I forgot about that shit.
He was on Love & Hip Hop for a very long time.
He was the fuck on Love & Hip Hop.
So,
yeah, he was on Love & Hip Hop. Do you think honestly, that is Love & Hip Hop, Joe, or more so?
I forgot.
Podcast Joe.
Damn.
And what about
who's bigger? Bags or bags?
I think it depends on who you're asking. I think there's a space of people who only know Love & Hip Hop, Joe.
Women.
Yeah.
Well, yeah,
they're the only ones.
I forgot
that
about that period in his life. That's a big period in this nigga life.
That is,
because that's how he got kind of back.
Proposing to everybody.
I would go on Love. Would you go on Love & Hip Hop?
Marry me. Yeah, I would.
If you was on Love & Hip Hop, what would be your archetype? Who are you? What are you? Who you dating? What you doing?
I would just be the dickhead boyfriend.
To who?
Ew, no.
Just come on. Just take me back.
I don't want to be on camera.
I don't even cheat. Like,
so you'd be Jim Jones.
She sucked my dick.
Jim Jones.
That's
what Jim Jones was.
Was he?
He didn't want to be on camera and shit at first.
No, I would want to be on camera.
But that was his thing. Now,
who
was
the girl's Tommy? Remember her? Remember her boyfriend bought her flowers and she
Scrap De Leon.
And then she like Scrap ran De Leon, into his arms. That's a crazy name. Mm.
Tommy?
She was
Tommy
taking was the roses and throwing them at him. Then he was like, you know what?
In a sexy way or a bad way?
No, in a bad way. And he's like, you know what? I'm going to leave and I'm going to let you cool down. She's like,
well,
let me walk you out because I don't know why you were treating me. He was like, the look on his face was like, this bitch is fucking crazy. I would fuck her though.
Yeah. Tommy?
Yeah, she got it like that.
I would fuck the skin off of Phaedra Parks, though.
God damn it.
I feel like she looks the same in person. NeNe Leakes looks the same in person, probably.
NeNe Leakes probably don't look the same in person,
She probably looked better.
Go Tiny. Go Tiny.
You, Samaj, the faces Samaj makes?
No, I'm...
Yeah, Phaedra Parks, yeah.
What's the other one named, though?
Portia, though.
Portia.
Oh, that's who the fuck I'm talking about. Wrong person, wrong bitch.
Portia looks the same, I bet.
Yes.
Because Portia goes on TV sometimes, like, with no makeup on.
Portia goes hard. That's where Portia does go.
Let me try to find her Instagram.
Portia can go. Let me find the intro.
It might be Portia Go Body in now.
Oh, Portia for real with a number 4.
Yeah, yeah.
This who I was talking about, bro.
Whew.
Yeah.
And she's like, what's she like, 40-something?
Yeah, but the nigga that she dating.
Millionaire.
Is that crazy? That's not nice to say.
Simon Go Body.
Who am I? He could be a good person.
But he not a looker. His pockets is. What are we talking about?
Talking about being a good person
overall. Oh, okay.
We're not supposed to judge people,
You're absolutely right. I was just...
Who's the boy dating from the Central Park 5?
He was... Nope.
Jesus, that scared the shit out of me. Delicious.
No,
was it delicious?
Delicious, yes.
I mean to hit the foul.
Raymond Santana.
Raymond Santana, yeah. You know Remy Santana, right?
I gotta stay off of... Delicious?
No, that's not Remy Santana.
Who's Delicious?
From Love & Hip Hop. Oh, Love & Hip Hop.
Oh.
She knows. Yeah. She's from Flavor of Love.
Oh, Flavor of Love, yep.
Jesus.
That's not Delicious?
That's Delicious right here.
Oh, I thought you said Raven Santana.
No,
this Raymond was dating, from The Exonerated Five.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Very different.
Very different.
Very different.
They're not together no more, though. Right?
What did he do?
I don't but why you assume it's him?
Huh?
It gotta be him. She wanted to leave his ugly ass.
It gotta be him. I'm doing everything in my power. If I look like a regular ass nigga, which I do, and like...
You don't look regular. You a handsome brother.
Come on, now, stand up.
That's probably what his nigga is telling him. And that's exactly what the fuck got him caught up. This nigga thought he was the nigga because he had Delicious. Because
if you get a bad bitch, man, she pipe you up.
You was a normal looking nigga. Stop it. You was a normal looking motherfucker. Stop it.
I'm not doing
it. No, if you get a bad bitch, she pipe you up. And then you... He what?
He's good looking.
Raymond Santana?
I mean, he too light for me, but he all right.
Okay. Shout out to Raymond.
Shout out my nigga Gucci.
Shout out my nigga Gucci.
That nigga got... He got...
He got to clap
the butts. You can't take that away from him.
He clapped the butts.
He had her. He had her. You can't take that away from her.
I'd have gave a baby to her. I'd have gave her a baby.
After that, you could literally just, you could die, honestly. You could just be like, all right, cool.
I'm spreading my seed. I lived a good life.
And her?
Let's go ahead.
For sure.
She might not. Okay, let's go to something else.
The die behind it.
That's how you podcast the show, guys. That's how you produce a podcast.
Lionel, it's not playing.
Uh-oh.
It's that 15.
It's not connecting.
Don't say
it's not benecting for all the blood.
That shit not benecting blood.
You better chill out.
They gonna find me.
I'm glad we don't live in like LA where they niggas can find us.
Nigga like me.
Go
I'm unfindable.
Y'all be in the same space as a
blood?
No. Come on, you know this.
You ready? I know a blood.
No.
I know a Crip, nigga. Who?
Are you serious?
Yeah, who? Wayne's a Crip?
That nigga ain't no fucking Kurt.
That nigga ain't no
he fucking. He a blip. Kurt. That's what he is.
He a fucking.
I'm going to be very clear, Wayne. You see, I ain't
he
say
a
nothing.
Fucking grip.
Wayne look like a thumb. That's my man, though.
No, you don't look like no thumb. I know some people that look like.
No, Wayne look like no
we
thumb.
We know some
man.
Motherfuckers that look like
we know some thumbs.
We know some thumbs, and they right up in here up in that motherfucking chat. Shout out to Mariah's lit. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Lionel, you ain't want to?
Hey, look, man.
I'm not taking
shout
that out
shout out to all my BBWs in the world.
I'm not taking it out.
Shout out to all my big women's, my BBWs. You know what I'm saying? You got a lot of fat on that back, a lot of butt on that on them thighs. Shout out to you.
Yes.
We love you.
And I'm going to stop backing him. I noticed that I'll be backing him in the clips. In the clips and stuff, whenever he say something stupid, I'll be like,
yeah. Come on, And it's literally
I gotta stop,
because
you know what I'm realizing? That's fueling.
It's fueling the
bullshit.
It's like a pipe up.
That's what it is.
Notice, I be thank you. Because
you can't pause yourself. That's
no, but yeah, you can't.
Sometimes you finish the you start the sentence, and you know it's going to draw. Shout out to my, I got it.
That's not a pause at all.
Okay,
and you know it.
Okay. Shout out to my skinny minis.
Shout out to that. Yeah. Shout out to regular size people.
Yeah.
People that are normal size. And you know who that is?
They don't get enough love.
That's all of you.
Yeah.
Everybody's normal size.
Everybody's
who gives
normal.
A fuck, honestly.
OMG.
When was the last time anybody gave a fuck? Because I don't.
Me either.
I don't give a fuck.
Me either. Everybody's normal. Nobody's different from each other.
We're all the same.
And all the women out the Mariah Scientist Factory are just different.
They all look the
same
alike.
Factory.
I like them.
Same
I like
factory.
That. I like that archetype.
That's an interesting archetype.
It's a really interesting archetype.
You know who else archetype need an archetype? Ace Hood girlfriend. What's her name? What's Ace?
Because I know she looked like something. I remember people was like.
What's Ace Hood girlfriend name?
I don't fucking know.
You don't follow Ace Hood?
No, who follows Ace Hood?
Yeah, that's
Hood?
A crazy question.
It is
brother.
2023.
I'm about to
see.
Play
he
Ace
probably posted. Oh, that's
we
his daughter.
We give body that body.
Oh, here she go. This her?
Yes.
Black Love.
Yes.
That's kind of annoying too. I ain't even going.
I do hate that. Now I hate her.
This her right?
Sheila Marie. Yes.
Yeah. She's a. That's her archetype.
She's cool. She's good.
Yeah, she is. She's really cool. That's cool. Do you think you fall in the archetype?
No.
Are you talking to me?
Oh, brother, we have a podcast together.
What is wrong with this nigga? This is the most silent he's ever been.
Brother, this is literally a podcast with us. I said, do you think you have a...
What the fuck? Did you just short circuit?
This is a nasty joint, right? This is the joint that... what you call it? I was still hitting because I'm disgusting, but that Zion was falling for her.
Yeah. Oh, that's a little crazy.
That shit drawn, bro.
That's too much, brother.
That's too much ass.
She the one that was hating?
That was like, baby mom. Wasn't that her? No, this the one that was on
that's
some
the one
weird
that was
shit.
Hating.
Yeah.
Oh my God,
Zion. That's drawn, bro. Yeah, that's fake, right?
Yeah, what's another song he got? Baby, we don't need no script.
Script for this.
I'm a fool, I got my nonsense, baby. Strip. Let me pull my camera out and make a movie.
You wanna hear your body drip, drip, drip? While I taste them sexy lips, I'm not afraid to drown. If that means I'm deep up in your ocean,
isn't that person
cute? I wanna lay you down.
First of all, you just can't sing that.
On your body, y'all.
You can't sing that.
Who that?
Think about it, brother.
There's a feature in that song.
Oh, is it? Who's the?
No, it's not.
Is that not Chris Brown and R. Kelly?
That's Ludacris. That's Ludacris and Chris Brown.
Oh, I'm thinking of a different... He has a song with R. Kelly.
That. He do, but that's
whoa.
Not...
That's how he did it. The boy was like this.
What?
Did he later on got it? He was throwing the money out of his pocket. You didn't remember that nigga?
No.
The Milwaukee nigga? The Milwaukee nigga that be dancing to that shit.
No,
Big Man?
Is new. This is new.
It's a TikTok thing.
Oh, we don't get on that.
You don't.
Yes,
get
you
fucking,
do.
Loser.
He lives on there.
Kevin McCall and Chris Brown had a crazy run.
Yes, yeah. They
so
did.
Kevin McCall got
start
the
beating
Eva
bitches
pussy.
Up.
Oh, well, there we go.
Sorry.
Yep. Is that what he was doing?
Uh-oh.
Yes. You don't know he was.
Kevin McCall was too.
He was beating the shit out of her.
They was the hit
both
brothers.
Both of them.
Both of them niggas.
His squad.
Which nothing, is not.
That's not funny,
that.
Y'all.
I'm not laughing.
And neither am I.
I'm not Bill laughing. Fuck both of them niggas. Honestly. They beat on women. I don't listen to their music. Their music don't beat on my ear drums. So fuck them niggas. I don't listen to them niggas. I don't listen to Chris Brown. Niggas be like, Chris Brown dropped the 50-track album. Fuck that nigga. He hit somebody.
Chris Brown about to go on tour and that shit gonna sell crazy.
That shit gonna go out.
Because guess who's gonna be there?
Out. They be like, she apologized. People be like, I don't wanna hear it. And guess where I fall? Nowhere within that. I fall in the group that watches cat videos because I don't give a fuck about what either one of them is talking about. I don't
guess
know what to do. Who do I? What side do I pick? I don't know. Because I like both of them.
Once you get a beat a chick up allegation,
that's it.
A beat a chick up allegation.
Because Kevin, what's the boy's name? Jonathan Majors. Oh,
yeah, Jonathan Majors.
His shit kind of clear, but like he's still not finna get them deals back.
No, that's
yeah, that's kind of crazy.
Going.
Yeah, that's fucked
he
up.
He a good actor too.
I don't
but that's
know.
That's the
that.
Reason why
he acted like he didn't do it. Sorry.
I mean, do you think he did it?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
I hope not because that's
it was a white woman though, right? Like it was a white woman.
That's a big motherfucker to
that's
be
a,
smacking
a,
motherfucker.
You too big to be beaten down on a bitch.
Yeah,
it's a size limit.
You can't after you get to a certain size, you cannot be putting your hands on bitches because you're too big.
Yeah, I feel that way.
And he's too big.
I got a question.
I feel that way about Dwight Howard too.
No, I said he was too big.
That's a big nigga.
Yeah.
That's a big nigga.
Can you mute this real
with
quick?
The cut? With the no wait with the cut.
I'm about to walk in, walk out.
Oh,
we was on. We was on a bunch of different stuff.
Okay, so I have a question. I have a question.
Not too high. Because it might peak.
I have a question.
Yeah.
I have a question. All right. If Jesus is
let me stop you there.
If Jesus was 5'5", do y'all think that we would still respect him? Like if he was under 5'5"?
Jesus was a short nigga.
Jesus Christ. If Jesus was short. Like if Jesus came back, that's why I want to meet my idols. If Jesus came back and he was 5'5", and he like, yo, like, I mean, like, get right.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, cuz. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you 5'4". What you saying to cuz? I'm going to respect him because of who he is.
Yeah, I guess, because here's the thing. We hang out with short niggas. You know a 5'5 nigga.
You.
I know a lot of 5'5 niggas.
You know a 5'3
nigga. I just be looking at them like this.
Who I know that's short?
Who? Come on, brother. Come on, brother. Not here. Not now.
Oh, cuz?
Yeah.
Yeah, but he not Jesus.
No, yeah. But he's just saying, like, you know,
which somebody. which is even like, you know, Jesus came for a reason.
This nigga,
I'm gonna laugh
here.
A little bit behind his.
Pause,
nigga. He did came for a reason. He came.
Yep.
He did probably. All I'm saying is, what if you find out something else about him though?
Tired of the way he treats me. Tired. What is that from?
What would Madea? You do? What would you do if you found out if it was something else?
If God was what?
Not God, Jesus, brother. Don't.
But find
not
out what?
That man.
If somebody was 5'5"?
Is he 5'2" or is he 5'2"?
Big tits. I fell in love with the lip bit. Hey.
Remixing big tits. To 504.
What did you ask me? What if you found that out?
Did I help? What?
No, that he.
That he what, Lionel? What?
You not putting two and two together and it's making me mad.
Can you type it?
Why don't you? You get it?
Tomorrow's don't get it either. Can you type it? Well, I don't think he's so smart. He think he put that joke together so well. He missed everybody. Everybody who's been coming back listening to us, make sure y'all touch them podcast reviews too as well. Don't forget about that.
Do I go to hell for this? Because I could easily just say, God, I don't want to go to hell for this.
Oh, no. Come on, man. Come on, dog. Come on. But you know what?
You don't respect him then?
To have them type of superpowers, he might.
That take a lot of focus.
That take a lot
you
of focus,
really
yeah.
Be like, me?
Yeah. But you know what?
Shout out to that nigga, though. Because when he get here, I'm going to be like this. Yeah. I'm going to be like this.
What's up with you, cuz? Jesus is definitely black.
I look down on him like this. Yeah. Right?
I don't know why they try to tell us that.
Saying looking down on Jesus is insane.
He said he was 5'5".
You got to get on your knees.
Could you go, Lionel, Lionel, if you don't mind, if you could just.
Yeah.
You're not the keeper of the pause button.
You are
bro.
Not the keeper of the pause button.
What the fuck is wrong with
That's
you?
A community pause button.
Like, literally.
You like to hold the community penis button, brother.
You wanna know who got the word he just said about Jesus? You. You might be the holder of it.
That's the community.
You might be the holder
button,
of it. Bro. You might be the holder
literally
of it.
Every time you say some pause shit, that's what this for.
I wanna hold the button.
And you hold it.
I'm the butt holder.
All right, you are.
Speaking of holding butts and ass and titties.
I didn't think that's where we were going, but that's fine.
I'm going to keep it a bean, right? When you a nigga, or when you a person who likes butt and pussy, and you fuck your first fat ass butt, that shit really changed your life. It changed your mentality on things. I felt like Superman once I handled my first fat ass butt. Like, you know what I'm talking about?
The first time you had, like, extraordinary ass. No, like it was like...
It was some shit you used to see on TV and shit.
Yeah.
And you like, yo, like and you this, sitting there.
Yeah.
And when you look and you go, oh my gosh, like.
I would like, never thought I was going to be here.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
I get it, bro.
Oh I get my it. God.
It was a question on
Twitter. Oh my God.
It was a question
I'm
on
Twitter. I'm about to get up and leave.
Whoa. It was a question on Twitter, right?
I don't know what's going on tonight.
That's how I retain, and they said, that's how I retain from
busting
blasting off. I'd be like this. I might turn stupid a little bit.
Okay. There was a question on Twitter, right? Hold on. Let me answer this.
How do y'all listen to this? Oh, for all the listeners,
make
sure y'all rate. Make sure y'all rate us on.
After I just said it? Are you Anyhow.
Yo, take yes. that test.
After, it was a question on Twitter that said, what do niggas even be thinking about when they hitting it from the back? And we're going to tell you.
We're going to tell you.
Number one, if you're looking down and there's a nice butt there, and a lot of niggas like myself are appreciative of being in some nice butt. So I'm looking down. I'm like, damn, you really getting into this, huh? And then I'm like, I think about her career. Like, you might be like
I think about her career.
I do. I'd be like, you might that be like a receptionist. And I'm just like, damn, they don't even know you a freaky, slutty ass receptionist.
Oh.
I'm like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
In real world, you just like so, but in the bedroom, you just.
I'll tell you, like, so at first
and you hold
thought,
it open, nasty teacher.
At first thought, I'd definitely be surprised.
It I do be
that.
Surprised.
It's like, wow, I cannot believe that you accepted me. You let this happen. Cool.
Right.
Then it's more like the, what do I do next? Because I gotta show out in this thing.
Yeah, for sure.
It's time to show out. It's time to show out in this motherfucker.
It's time to show out and it got done.
It's time to put on a show.
No bullshit.
And then right after that comes, don't come. don't come.
That's number three. The final stage that's the looking down is
no. The final stage come. Is honestly, I came.
Yeah.
It's the fuck. It's the fuck stage.
Yeah. Fuck.
I came. Fuck. Damn it.
Yeah.
God damn it.
There's a midpoint of like, I'm about to come, but I don't want to come because this feel good, but this nut's gonna feel better. So yeah. It's like, in the, as a nigga, you balancing that in your head, and you like,
oh yeah,
I'm gonna just let this off.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know how you get to the point where you about to bust and you start stroking real quick, like, are you controlling the strokes?
Yeah.
But she tried to do like this, the dominant shit. You better not fucking come, right? But you already,
you already made up
your mind where it's too late. Like you leaned over to this side too much, where you can't be like, all right, I'm gonna bring it back.
Yeah.
You already leaned it too far.
Yeah.
So now you're going to get this regardless of what you just said.
Yeah.
It's over with.
Whenever she tell me, like, don't come, I'll be like, well, you better pick a spot.
You better
tell me where it's going.
Yeah.
Guess what? It's happening, sister girl.
I've been trying to figure it out.
Pick a spot.
Stop saying sister girl.
Yeah. Boop. Where am I going?
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
Guess where it's going?
Inside of you.
For fuck's sake.
Spread around that body. I think our nut gives a woman power, right? That's my shit. Why you start saying that?
Cause it's inside.
That's my song.
Inside.
When I got a candle lit, that's it.
Who is that? Steve Lacy, right?
Steve Lacy.
Inside.
During the pandemic, that was my candle light in my crib songs.
Yeah.
I had a playlist full of Steve. That shit.
Steve Lacy.
Daniel Caesar.
You're talking.
Daniel Caesar.
Lucky Day.
Lucky Day.
You play Lucky Day?
I do.
Yeah. Lucky Day for sure.
Floods. That song.
Aaron Ray for sure. Come on now.
Anderson .Paak with the band he had, the Free Nationals.
Yeah.
He had some shit too.
Yeah. Live instrumentation will do it.
Yeah.
We're at that age now.
Yeah.
Where live instrumentation
will do it.
You go to a dinner and it's like live instruments playing.
And it's a didgeridoo going crazy.
You are that nigga.
Yeah.
I'm not going anywhere where there's a didgeridoo. There's no didgeridoo. It's something wrong with you.
You ever heard of didgeridoo?
What? What's your. Yo, this is like the y'all talked about me, right? A didgeridoo.
You talked about me, right?
But we already.
How do you spell didgeridoo?
Big tiz, not the little one.
Come on now, not the little one.
Not the little
Look
one.
How I'm spelling
all
it.
All big.
Oh.
All big tiz popping and little shit stopping. You feel me?
Here's a
this motherfucker. Look at him.
Look, he don't care. He's still. You have played we this get for it. Us already. We, get it. We know We've you like the didgeridoo. First of all, don't.
That
do
sound
this.
Like the Andre 3000 album. All right, come on.
We don't give a fuck.
Come on. We hear it, brother. We hear it. They get it. They got it.
That shit's smooth, huh?
Yeah, look at what the video that you picked. What are you doing?
Who blew in the tree and said, yo, this shit hard? Like, look at this shit, bro. One more time.
It's a wind instrument. Yeah, they've had those for a long time, brother.
All right, back to the podcast, y'all. I just wanted y'all to hear a didgeridoo. Let me take this nigga off my screen because he's scaring me. I don't think I could survive.
You didn't even take it off the screen. You just lowered the brightness. Yeah. You're fuck like what the fuck?
I ain't
when
my
I
screen.
Said when I came in here, I you said something was wrong with him today.
Could have just hit X. Escape. That's what escape is.
That means
get out of there.
You hit me with a X. I'm like, the fuck is that?
Escape?
Yeah.
The word the X, the little X at the top of the window.
I'm not an escaper.
Okay.
I stay for it. Stay tight beat.
All right.
Yeah.
Insane.
All my people out there that play didgeridoo, holler at me. I want to start a didgeridoo band. If you play
what instrument did Benzino play?
He played fingernails. He played guitar.
I know you like that. That segue, right?
Yeah, that was good. That was good up top.
What did he do? I'm fat in the motherfucker. You feel me? Straight like that. Nigga like that. Get in there.
Damn.
I don't want fuck for real.
My fucking trap is my
God damn, the trap work, nigga. Straight trap. Nigga.
I seen this lady on, don't forget Benzino real quick, on TikTok.
Benzino that put, his neck.
That put,
or lack thereof.
That put, what's them bugs we got now? Them annoying
lantern?
Bugs. Put them in her, what you call it?
Her drink?
No, what? Her Venus flytrap. She got,
is that,
she found some type of.
No, she has a like bunch of these plants it. That eat
oh,
shit.
Oh, an actual Venus.
Yeah, actual Venus. You throw her. Oh, no, not her. No, not that. That's crazy.
Smosh.
I thought he was.
Trying to find another word for vagina. No. After all of this shit we done said.
Oh, my God. I got to go to bed. I got to go home.
Yeah. That's crazy. I feel you. What's going on with you?
Yeah. Actually, how was Samaj's week?
How are you? How was your week?
It was okay. I'm tired a little bit.
Yeah.
But it was okay.
It was one of those. What are you waiting for? What do you have anything coming up? next few weeks? Are you excited for anything in life?
No.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I'll tell you guys.
Like off camera?
Late.
Yeah. Yeah. It's some off camera shit. All right.
Come on.
Okay.
All right, I'm not mad at that.
Somebody just pregnant.
Not even everybody. A joke. Not even a
Lionel
joke, brother.
Lionel,
you know what I learned about? You know what I learned about speaking things into existence?
Please,
and how
look,
scary
seriously.
That can be for a lot of people.
What would you do if you was pregnant?
People wish
though?
Babies on me, and I am not
I don't
a
like
fan
that.
Of it.
I don't like.
I
that.
Am not a fan of people that like go either, like yeah. that. Say shit like, when are you gonna have a baby? Or I can't wait for your baby to be born. Or you're gonna be such a good dad. Or let's
going,
just hold up.
Let's just calm the fuck down.
You don't even know if I'm gonna be a good father. You don't know me.
You don't
in
even
that
know
life.
If I'm a good person
at all.
Calm
you
the
don't know.
Fuck down.
You don't know anything damn. About
really go.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't know anything about that. Also, I do have a bit of an ego, so when people say things, I do get a little excited. But you gotta stop.
You gotta fucking relax. Yeah.
I may smile when you say it, but yeah. deep down, I'm like,
I'm
what
like,
the
hey,
fuck?
What the fuck,
that could,
man?
That could be a thing.
That's true.
Relax.
Yeah, don't wish no babies on me. But what would you do if you got an announcement?
Baby announcement? What yeah. would my baby announcement be?
My shit going. I'm gonna make a movie. I'm gonna make a skit.
Oh, you know what I'm gonna do? You remember back in high school when niggas was crashing niggas' phones? They was using that app. You would send a text to somebody and it would crash their phone if they no. opened up the text message.
What yes. the fuck's their phone?
You remember that?
I remember
it
that.
Was an app back
it was
in the
iPhones
day.
Or it was other phones?
It was iPhones.
Oh.
And you would have to literally have to shut your whole phone down and then restart it in order for it to be a whole thing.
Let's bring that back.
Yeah, but in baby reveal, though. That would be oh. my baby reveal. Oh. She's sending it to people, shutting their phone down. Just like the last message they read is... I got a baby, y'all. And
I'll
then it would shut
you
your
up,
whole phone
yo.
Down. You would have to literally restart
you.
Your whole phone.
Absolutely, I'll fight you. Because yeah. why are you doing that?
Yeah, I would do that.
Okay.
That's how I would do it. Either that or
I would,
fly something in the sky.
What would I do? I don't know, because you only get one shot to do that shit. You only
to
get
tell
one.
People that you got a baby.
Yeah, just like, what would you post? Like, the ultrasound, that's kind of regular. But ain't that? But that's some shit that's common, but it's kind of cool, though.
Yeah.
I think ultrasound is kind of cool. I'm not mad at that.
No, I'm not mad at that either.
I like when people do, like, if I come in here and bring y'all, got it.
Oh.
Like, bring a shirt or
can
something.
Can that be the screenshot?
Oh, and it say Uncle
says,
Steve
like,
or something
yeah,
like that.
Like,
yeah.
Just been upgraded
oh, that's
to
cool.
Uncle.
Oh, that's pretty
that's
cool.
That's pretty dope. I seen a lady on TikTok get that, and she kept not understanding it was a mom.
Oh.
The older mom. And she was like.
The grandma?
She just was looking at the shirt. Yeah. She was just like. Okay. And somebody had to say. So-and-so's pregnant, and she's like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
I think I might have seen
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I'm like, the
you
fuck?
Know which ones I don't like is when they use the pregnancy test as a like a
like the one
straw.
That got peed on?
The
what?
Girl put it, yeah, the girl put it in the girl's drink, and the girl started stirring up her drink with it.
Okay.
I've never seen
like, it was
that.
Like, yeah, it was a thing on TikTok repugnant. Where it was like a group of girls, and they like, the one friend that didn't know, they put it in her drink.
Oh.
They thought that it was funny.
That's not funny.
It was not funny at all.
There's a lot of germs in there.
And they wanted her to take it out and look at it, but she started sipping on the drink. And it was like, wow. Oh, here's that.
She got some pussy pink lemonade.
Yeah. I wish I had some pussy pink lemonade.
Same.
That's reminding me of some
you know what?
Things.
Yeah.
Got a busy weekend ahead of me.
This was great. Oh, man.
Okay.
One yeah. day I'm gonna go. Everybody's going to be right. We're going
to
be solid.
Look at Samaj's face. I just want you to... Can you just look straight? Look at that thing on your face.
I'm trying to take my earring out.
Why are you taking a picture of that?
Because I'm about to say something.
Oh, my God.
So look, right?
Okay.
Do we need to, like, turn the volume, cut the volume?
No.
What the fuck?
What goes on?
Do you?
Who I'm talking about?
I don't know. I'm just excited for you to miss somebody. Oh. I can't be excited about that.
You know how you just next topic. Let's go.
Yo, quick. This gotta be the most.
Sometimes you don't want to make a call. You don't want to make. You don't want to. You know what I'm saying? Like just
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Sometimes you don't.
It's got to be exhausting. In your head.
Sometimes
autism.
You don't.
Yeah.
Sometimes you don't want to like.
Yeah.
Bother somebody. You feel me?
Lionel, stop saying yeah.
You keep it. No. You don't hit them up because I'm like I don't want to bother that person. So you just let them move.
No.
Usually I'd be like, fuck it. I'm gonna disturb your peace right now, but
you know
I
what
don't
you
want
do?
To.
You send a text message and you throw the phone.
I swear to God, I've done that.
Unsend it. They'll see it.
You know they still get the notification.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's why.
But then it makes you like
that's
a,
literally
like
the same thing. That's the same thing. Yeah, that's the same thing. Yeah, you send a message and then you throw it. Throw the phone.
I throw my phone like I'm scared at. Scared of it.
Yeah, throw it in your room.
Say no more.
And then, like, ah!
And then once you throw it.
And it's gone.
Get it out. Get
and then you check it. Ain't nothing on the screen.
You go de-stress. Yeah, and then they text you back.
Yeah, they text you
it
back.
It just says delivered.
Yeah, that's it.
You got your read receipts on?
Negative.
I do.
No,
that's bad.
Yeah.
Should I turn you should, I feel like everybody should turn them on.
For what?
Send it with dignity.
No.
Send your messages with dignity.
No.
Who are you hiding from? You're not everybody. Pussy. Yes. You're a grown ass man slash woman slash he, they, them. Him, they,
baby.
Them. Whoever, yeah. Her. You're that.
I'm not doing no re-receipts.
Put your re-receipts on. Everybody,
I thought
challenge
it was red receipts.
Re-receipts November.
I thought it
re-receipts
was
December.
Red receipts.
No, not even close.
Re-receipts December. Re-receipts all 2024.
Re-receipts 2024.
Keep
not
them on.
It. No,
fuck it.
Doing
who
it.
Cares?
No.
You send that text message with dignity. That's all I'm saying.
No, because like.
It's not about
what are we
the
running
one
from?
You send. It's about the one you read.
Receive, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
What?
Because it's
I
like.
I don't care.
Because I'm good for. Yeah. No.
You can ignore me. I don't want to see that you ignore me on purpose. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to see you say red at 3:24 and it's 7 o'clock.
But you know what? It's good that you got to know that because now you got to just.
And you
out.
Know where you fall in line.
I got it. You don't care about me. Cool. This is where we are. It's cool. That's
you
validation.
I'm going to go fuck myself.
You validated fine. It for you. You know what? You just told me that you don't give a fuck about
you really
me.
You don't give a fuck.
I'm glad I know where I stand.
That's a good point.
You got another nigga? Cool. Another bitch? Cool. All right.
You just sucked some dick. It's not even that deep.
Oh my God, please help me. Cause it's just not fair.
It's not. I mean, it's not.
It's not, though.
It's a little crazy.
I was like, you're not my bitch.
Now you acting like you're not.
All right. Now you why you do that?
You ever see a shorty, like pop up with a new nigga and then you just gotta like
be
either left?
Or no?
That's hilarious.
Just trying to be funny.
What?
Are you trying to be funny?
About what?
No.
Puss.
And now you just gotta let. Uh oh.
I told you.
What song are you listening to?
I said something
bro.
Wrong with this nigga today.
I'm chilling.
What song are you vibes. Listening to yet?
Fuck will you hoe? I don't want you back. Oh, not that. What you singing? Oh yeah. That nigga had. I had a conversation about somebody this week, right? Not this week.
About somebody?
No. I have a conversation with somebody.
Bloody hell.
In a certain point in time. Yeah. A little while ago. And they were talking about a hit record, right?
Talking a boot.
And they said that a hit record was a record that was popular on TikTok, too. And I said, that's not a hit record. Mm-mm. A TikTok popular sound record is not a hit fucking record to me.
Okay.
A hit record is something that's like... Cause you know, like I equated it to this. Coi Leray had a big ass record on TikTok.
She did
a show.
Players, right?
She did some shows.
Yeah.
Off of them records, and nobody came to them shows.
Okay.
Because that really didn't get off of the app. That was like
they
a sound.
They don't know the song. They just know that
the part.
Know
that
yeah.
part.
Now, hit record is something that's it can be viral on TikTok. It stand like you know might stand in terms of time or whatever, but it's also
a hit.
Just a you
it's
know
a standalone.
Lotto job. Get it on the flow. That shit. Mm-hmm. That's a hit, right? Cardi B and them.
Yeah.
WAP. That's a hit record.
Mm-hmm. So are we saying like things that you could play in the club?
Not even the club. A hit record. Because some shit don't got to go in the club.
Shit just don't ring off in the club.
Kendrick Lamar. Some of his Kendrick Lamar shit don't ring in the club. But that's
but
shit
a hit,
just
though.
Hit records.
Yeah. I feel like that's what a hit is though, right? Like a hit
they
is
said
something
that them girls song was a hit.
That's something in the club.
They said them running girls song was a hit.
Because I got mini men.
Is that a hit record?
Because I like cinnamon.
Is that a hit record?
His
is that a hit record?
Finnegan.
That's not a hit record, right?
I'm about to sin again.
I was about to say, hey, yo, Clyde.
I'm getting a minute. I'm getting a minute.
I'm winning.
But it could be big. It could be viral. But I don't think it's a hit record.
Yeah. I agree with that. That's not a hit record. No, that's not a hit.
But they are
getting money.
We barely
money,
halfway
so
that's
know what they're
good,
saying.
That's so good.
But that's not a hit record.
But that's not a hit, though.
It's not a hit record.
It's not a hit. And I bet you if they... like watch this and was like, I bet you, look at what we did.
So they
we're not saying
the
y'all not popping.
Yeah, y'all
I'm
are,
just saying
y'all
your
are,
shit not a hit record.
Y'all are doing y'all thing. I like that.
Yeah.
I got friends again.
I don't think that's crazy.
Citizen.
They did a Domino's commercial. I was hating.
Yeah, I was hating too when I
why
seen
why can't
that
we
shit.
Do a pizza commercial? Oh, we got something to play on the podcast today. I'm
big
pizza.
Yes.
You going to DMs or Twitter?
I know exactly what it is.
That is what we're out here.
Why does Joel Embiid have 8 assists? Brother, get a fucking rebound, nigga. What are you doing?
Oh, he not doing enough for you? You put money down?
Yeah, I did.
Stop betting, bro.
Stop
doing
that.
Brother, I'm telling you, I am done with niggas, yo. I am so done with these basketball players. All my legs hit in this parlay that I had. I'm going to go to Twitter right now. I totally forgot. All my legs hit in this parlay that I had, and except for Klay Thompson. I'm watching a game with Klay Thompson. This nigga can't even get a fucking bucket. He went 1 for 10.
Lionel,
this nigga shot
words.
10. This nigga shot 10. He shot the ball 10 times at the hoop and only made it once. Are you fucking dumb? I feel like I can at least do it 3 times.
POV,
I'm mad at it.
A nigga put money down on the game.
And about to come up so big.
And lost.
I was about to feed the streets.
What's your name?
Yeah. You know who I was about to feed the streets?
Who?
Danny. Sweet. Danny Garza.
We're going to play y'all a record from a boxer from Philly that was once one of the greatest. He's still great. But he lost a few fights. And this is what he's doing now with his time.
Y'all ready?
Yep.
Y'all ready for this?
Is it YouTube?
Are you ready? TikTok. I mean Twitter.
Do that be sexy when like singers be like, are you ready?
Yeah.
Y'all ready?
Beyonce said, you ready?
You ready for this?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
What about when Jacquees said?
Are you ready? Are y'all ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Me cause I'm flyer than a motherfucker. DSG the ghetto boy, never been a buster. Fight like Buster, major bitch fluster. Fat ass buster, smooth like butter. Cuba link chain, Cartier frame. Hit the pussy good,
somebody's
can't forget
head.
The name. Maybach truck, swerving in my lane. Rosé drink, champagne for
the
pain. Champagne for the pain, pain. Make pussy rain, rain. Champagne for the pain, pain. Made the pussy rain.
That's a fact. He gonna make it back down there.
Champagne. or
yo, if he don't get
rain.
That, if he don't get that tiger ass, kid ink ass beat the
that's
fuck out of there. Yeah. He sound like he tries to like French Montana.
Champagne. So what is it?
Champagne for the pain.
Champagne for the pain. Or
make the pussy rain.
Or make the pussy rain.
Which one is it?
You tell me.
It's a no.
Is it?
It's gonna be a no for me, dog.
It's gonna be a no for me, dog.
Is it Uchi Wally or is it One Mike?
Is it One Mike?
Is it champagne for the pain? Because honestly, pussy feel like rain.
Beyonce has a song
yeah,
where she was calling promiscuous women hoes back in the day. What's the name of that song?
She was calling promiscuous women hoes?
Yep. Let's see. Let's go look that up. There's a song that Destiny's Child had.
I was about to say, is it Destiny's Child or is it Beyonce?
Destiny's Child's song about... hold on. This is going to be hilarious.
Champagne for the pain, huh?
No, we're
pussy
not.
Make
no.
You rain.
We're not.
Huh?
We're not doing that.
I don't know. Champagne. No. Champagne for the pain.
We're not gonna be doing that. I'm so sorry.
When the last time you drank champagne for the pain?
Never. I can't say I have.
Right. I'm telling you.
No, we're gonna get this on tonight.
Paranoid. I'm tripping. I've been smoking.
And drinking.
I'm fucking around with you, bitch.
Well, she was like she was talking about she was talking about women that like don't cover themselves up. This slut is like have some respect for yourself and all.
What's
that.
What's the name of it?
I'm trying to find it because we're gonna play this. Fuck.
Well, I don't know how do you feel about. So we just played Danny Swift Garcia rapping, and that was. How do you feel about people chasing their dreams?
They should stop.
In situations like that. Like, you're a boxer, you know?
No.
I mean, he may be done boxing.
I hate people turn rappers. Just shut up.
Mm.
Whoa.
I think it's just like, come on, like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah, I used to play ball. I'm done now, so I always want to rap. Shut the fuck up and sit down.
Just say you couldn't progress.
Just shut the fuck up about it. Because we don't want to hear it.
Why not? Why couldn't he just have become like a boxer, like
turn philanthropist or something? I don't know.
Philanthropist is crazy, but I mean, there's just so many other things. Like he could be a trainer. He could literally just own a boxing
gym. How about let's stay in your field
Yeah, like, why not? Why didn't it? Why does everything have to be attached to just rapping or selling crack?
Fucking women and.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, I honestly, just... why?
Stick I don't a get fork it. In this America.
Nasty girl, can you go ahead and play Beyonce Nasty Girl? When
Nasty
you get a
girl.
Chance? Let's go ahead and let's just break down how judgy Beyonce was being in '99.
Well, guess girl. What? We're not about to do Beyonce slander.
Oh, we're not going to slander. I love Beyonce. I love Beyonce. It's Nasty. Called yep.
Nasty girl.
It's just hilarious. That's a video.
Oh, Beyonce. Destiny's Child. Destiny's Child. Yeah.
The child of
Destiny. You want to break down a dumbass song? Fucking cash your rubber band.
The words. Can you hear it? Oh, I gotta play from the top. You ready?
Oh, yeah.
We started.
Like, why is she doing this, bro? this is the most fucking judgy song.
Yeah, that's not that's hate.
That's hate, bro. That's true
that's
hate.
That's hate, bro. That's hate.
These men don't want no hot female. What?
Nasty shaking that thing on that man.
Looking all stay. It's not playing. We can't hear it.
You wanna we can't play this shit?
Oh true.
Oh, they might take it down, huh?
Yeah, let's
fuck around with
go listen to Nasty Girl,
Nasty
Girl
by Destiny's Child.
By Destiny's Child.
You sleazy, you freaky. I never met a girl that does the things you do.
It's like a porno. What
the fuck are they talking about?
She's a
Nasty.
Slut.
Put some clothes on, I told you.
Like, what? Who wrote that?
Flirting with every man she sees. Her pants hanging low. She never say no. Yo.
Destiny's Child was judging people. I mean, Beyonce would never perform that song right now. She won't perform. I just wanted to perform some Destiny's Child song at one point in my life, but she won't, and that's okay.
Why do you keep bringing Destiny's
Child? I love Destiny's Child. I feel like when Beyonce gets a residency, which I don't think she would do anyway, but she had to be like 60 if she do that shit. Like, just get a residency.
She can do it now.
She can, but she won't.
How long do you have to be at the residency for?
As long as you want, you
work
out a contract.
On how long the contract
Usher
is, right?
Apparently doing 10 years.
Get the fuck out of here.
No, I'm kidding. Okay. But he's been there for a while.
He's been there for kind of too long a little bit. Like, it's like, all right.
No, because I want to go see Usher.
Oh, okay. Until I go see Usher.
Yeah.
Skate around, perform.
Take my bitch and all.
Come like, sing to my girl.
Why y'all doing that?
I love, I'm just bad at it. I can't give it any of these bad habits. I had way too many ones.
What's
night?
The song where he'd be like, It's
bad.
Okay, girl.
Not with the song.
I'm sick
and tired of being at home. Oh.
That's the ultimate.
I'm glad y'all
like,
sung that because
homes.
Why was Usher in a club in the music video on Heelys? Let's get into that.
Nigga.
Let's break
There's
that down.
Nothing wrong with that.
Heelys is crazy
that's
in the club.
That's some fly ass
And that's
shit.
Back when he was wearing business casual in the club, too. But
Absolutely,
Heelys,
yeah.
Nigga said,
here's the part that I have, the problem that I have. He went through his entire wardrobe.
And that's what he came
picked
out the
out
house
everything
in.
And came out with some fucking Heelys on. That would have been the part that got me.
You ever walk in Heelys?
That would have been the shit that got me. You could only walk on the front part, right? Yeah, I don't.
You clicking as you walk.
This nigga like, had to do all of that.
You had to do all of that,
you
bro.
You walked into the club like that.
Ain't no. Actually, chicks
you
might be intrigued.
You told them your table. You said, I got a table tonight.
No,
what's
chicks,
up? We in this joint.
Chicks might be
well,
intrigued.
He's Usher.
He's Usher, yeah.
He just walk in.
Cuz could have walked in barefoot.
He
on his earthy shit.
Yeah.
Sure. Nasty, put some clothes on. I told you. Where was I going with this?
What did that come on while you're having sex? You stopping sex?
I'm trying to put his clothes on because you being that nasty hot girl.
I don't like
stop
the
flirting with every man you
like
see.
That's kind of some foreplay. That's foreplay music, honestly.
What that?
Yeah, tell it. Put your fucking clothes on, nasty. Nasty.
We fuck you through the hole.
Nasty. Put your clothes on. Nasty.
As they coming off.
Isn't that what she was saying to her, to the girls? Nasty.
Nasty.
You nasty.
Can I ask a question?
You trashy. You classless girl.
Oh, he reading the lyrics.
Classless girl.
You sleazy. You
called
freak.
Her a hot female.
You never met a girl that does the things you do. Nasty.
It do sound like foreplay.
Kinda, yeah,
without the
kinda,
beat, it kind of sound foreplay.
Yeah. If change don't come your way, it will come back to you. Nasty.
Michelle Williams could have got it too.
So could Kelly.
I creamed them jeans.
You would cream her.
Michelle's a gospel singer now, right? So I'm sorry.
Is she?
I'm really sorry though.
Praise be to the Most.
You have no class.
You were I'm classy.
Strongest for me.
Classless.
Nasty boy.
Nasty boy.
Where was I going with that?
Damn.
Wait, I had a point. Fuck. I lost it. We are at an hour anyway. Let's do some announcements. Real quick, we have Charlotte, North Carolina on January 21st.
Yes, sir.
Make sure y'all bring y'all assholes and asses to the John.
North Carolina.
Come on and raise up. Take your shirt off.
Turn around your head and like a helicopter.
North Carolina. Come on and raise up. This one for you.
This one's for who?
Us. Somebody just
everybody, if you're listening to this right now.
Things in there. Go ahead.
And you bought your tickets, let us know because we need to know who's all going to be there.
Yeah. We doing that to our own show. Who all gonna be there?
We need to know if the cool people are coming. It's like, no, you all are cool. I'm just fucking with you guys. But for real, make sure you check the bio. It's actually in the description of this episode.
Yep.
If you're listening, it's in the description. If you're watching,
it might be there right now. At this very moment, it will be there.
It will be in the description. It will be there. If you're watching,
I will copy and paste exactly what line to put into the from podcast app YouTube app.
Thank you.
I got to take out the arrows, though. YouTube don't accept that. They'd be like, YouTube be making anything a problem.
That's so stupid.
It's a fucking arrow.
That's stupid.
We got Kiwi letters.
But yeah, it's in the description, so make sure it's in our bio. Yeah, just come to the show, guys. It's fun.
What the fuck?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. What happened?
Hit the spin. Let's do it.
Oh, or do we? You don't have to play that song, do we?
No.
Do the thing. Strawberry. You don't have to. Just sing it. You got it? You ready?
I don't have it.
You don't got it any? No.
Not
today. You don't what?
You don't got it today. Okay.
Why do I have to sing it? Why can't you just play it?
Strawberry letter 22.
We know the rest of the words. That's all we know.
Yeah.
Let's get to it. So we got Kiwi letters.
All right. We got a couple of Cupid letters. Kiwi letters.
Cupid.
Sorry.
Jesus. All right. The first one.
Down my brain.
Read the crazy one first.
I did not read any of these. Apparently, it was one that was really crazy.
We talked about one of them.
Hi, y'all. I'm just going to get right to it. Okay. I'm engaged. The other night, my fiance was eating my box, and I closed my eyes, fantasized that it was Lionel. I almost said his name out loud. Should I be getting married?
No, you should the fuck
no,
not.
You simple fool.
Your husband is this nigga. I don't got no words for this nigga.
Thought about
his
me?
Fiance.
Hold on now.
You flattered.
You nasty girl.
You nasty
girl.
Nasty girl.
You so nasty.
Yeah. I mean, if she did that and it was her boyfriend.
She said, that's cool. I'm engaged.
Fiance is crazy.
First of all, no, fantasizing to the point of almost saying his name.
Yeah, yeah.
That means that she really was just like eyes closed. Like she was there with Lionel at that point.
Yeah.
It wasn't like a quick think about you, open the eyes up. She was like. Yeah.
I wish she left her voice, John, about it.
To hear her voice?
Yeah.
Say it. You want to hear the words? Say it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe you shouldn't do that. Maybe that's not
like
good.
I said,
for
please,
you.
Please don't do that
please
part.
Don't
maybe that's
do
not
that.
Good for your marriage. Yeah.
What, cuz? Dick corny or something?
It's just not Lionel's.
It's not mine. But hey, guess what? He's probably better than me.
That's great.
That's not.
Pause, nigga.
I'm trying to strengthen up their marriage. How is that a pause?
She don't want to strengthen.
She don't.
She clearly don't give a fuck about this nigga.
But is that all right? So let's take it off of them for a minute, because that's weird.
It's hard to.
Let's take it off of her.
There's a lot of buttons going on tonight.
Pause, nigga.
What?
Let's take it off of their marriage.
Okay.
Is it cheating if you think about somebody else?
I think it's unfortunate because if I'm fucking my wife. And my fiance and at both at the same time, wife and fiance.
Both of them.
And they are thinking about another nigga eating a pussy.
Like not even a nigga that they know.
Just like
she doesn't
a nigga
even
from
know
a podcast.
You. A nigga
worse,
off
no, no,
the
no,
screen.
It would be worse if she knew the person.
That's a great point. Great point.
It would be worse
great
if point. She knew the person because she actually knows the person.
Yeah, that's
me.
Yeah.
She
yeah.
don't know me. She just listened to me.
But
she
you
probably
get
seen
to know
me.
Lionel. It come to a lot. Charlotte, North Carolina, January 21st.
Why are you doing this to their marriage?
We need to Bring him.
I mean, bring him.
Bring him.
I'll like help with your marriage.
No. I don't think you can.
You Tyrese to DJ Envy?
Yeah.
Nigga said, I was helping you with your marriage, nigga.
What he say? I should really box your mouth.
I should box him up right now. I wanted to box your shit. You say, I wanted to box your mouth.
I would have been like, brother, what?
First of all,
what are you talking about?
I would not have been able to take him seriously. DJ box Envy your mouth. What an idiot.
He's a loser. Okay, so,
speaking of that,
Is it cheating?
Is it cheating if you think about somebody else during sex with your partner?
You need to keep that shit to yourself.
She said she was having sex with him?
Yeah. He was eating her box. Yeah.
I'm lost between is it cheating or not, because sometimes you do fantasize. Hopefully it's not a consistent fantasize with another person.
Yeah.
Because maybe at one point in time I was fucking somebody and thought about somebody else.
Yeah. Well,
you know,
I've done that before.
But I'll never get to the point where I almost say somebody's name like this. No.
Yeah, no. Mm-hmm. That's crazy. She almost wanted to say my name.
Lionel, were you here 2 seconds ago when I read it, or should I take it back?
Once my name got thrown in there, I kind of just was like, all right, this is crazy. Yeah.
My fiance was eating my box and I closed my eyes, fantasized that it was Lionel.
Wow.
I almost said his name out loud.
Damn it.
Should I be getting married?
His name
That's the question she want to answer to.
Should she be getting married? I mean, it's nothing wrong with your marriage.
We don't know how deep her problem, her issue goes with thinking about other people.
We're going off of solely what the young lady told us here.
Yeah, she don't need to get married. Don't get married to me.
I think you should get married. I just think that's to him.
Like, yes,
it's like, nothing wrong with, you know, thinking about other people. I just don't think you should do it a lot. And also, you know, don't tell him.
And also, like, don't.
Because the thing is, what if he's thinking about other people?
But what if she don't really like this nigga, though?
I think that's not what she said.
Because I feel like if I get to the point where I'm so close to fantasizing about another chick that I'm about to say her name, I might not be attracted to who I'm fucking. And I'm trying to raise my blood up to my meat. You feel what I'm saying?
Oh, like you're really trying to get it there.
Yeah, so that's I'm thinking about another chick. And it's like, maybe I'm not attracted to you that much.
If the person that you're with doesn't get you to the tipping point, is it really even...
Tipping point. I see what you did there. Got you.
No, I wasn't.
There's no excuses now.
You got me.
Stay on point. But yeah, when you get there, it's like, you might be losing attraction or you ain't really fucking with it.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Because sometimes I do. I be like, I close my eyes. I'm like this. But I'm like, I get right out of that shit. I'm like, I know who's sucking it right now.
You close it out real fast.
Yes, yeah.
Yes,
sometimes I go through a Rolodex in my head about all the best eaters I had when I'm getting my dick sucked. And I'm adding one to the collection, I'm like,
yeah.
That's crazy. Sorry, y'all.
That's insane. Who do you think you are? Future brother?
You don't know what to say.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. That was crazy. But as I'm getting some, I'm like, she doing the con. And I'm like, is she better than...
You started putting her in a place.
Yeah, she's
a placeholder. She's like second place, third place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you rank your top 5 hits?
Nope.
Initials.
Let's not do that.
Because I don't even want to do that. I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, that's insane.
Yeah, but that's I definitely can rank the top 5.
Next. Hey, guys. How do I tell a guy? Okay. How do I tell a guy I really like that us debating makes my P word wet? Because you know I don't say the P word.
Oh, them debating makes her pussy wet?
Yeah. I don't want to argue at all, but I want to hear your opinions or point of view. And you being able to communicate that turns me on. I hate when a guy agrees with me just to end the discussion or make me feel like I won something. I want to know what's going on in your head. I don't understand.
Yo, you's a freak. That's what that is.
Yeah, I'm confused on that.
You're a freaky McFreakster. You get off by arguing.
Not even. She wants to have like
a debate.
Political debate.
Yeah.
Just tell him.
Actually, global warning. Blah, blah, blah. Maybe that should be a new foreplay then. Maybe if you tell him like.
Yeah, this doesn't seem like a dilemma that we needed to solve.
I think if you just tell him like, hey, I kind of like when we.
Yeah, I like when we have intellectual conversation.
Is that what it is though? Because I feel like.
A debate is what she wants?
You can agree. Yeah, she likes when they debate.
Maybe that could be their foreplay. I don't know. Like, she could
I don't want to argue at all, but I want to hear your opinions or point of view, and you being able to communicate that turns me on. That's an intellectual conversation.
Yeah, but she said more though. Because I think she said, I don't want to hear you agree with
me. She said, I hate when a guy agrees with me just to end the discussion or make me feel like I won something.
That sounds like a debate more than
she
anything.
Sounds difficult to be with.
Why would you say that?
She does.
What if
I disagree with you because I don't care that much or I agree? I'm not, like, I don't want to debate.
That's dismissive, Steven, and you're gaslighting.
Can't say it's not that deep.
Can't be dismissive and say that's a stupid.
Sometimes I do be having conversations. I'm like, okay, like you're right.
Yeah, I think sometimes I'll just be like, all right, this is insane. But she just said that it just sounds like you and you need to just tell your person, whoever it is, that you like to have like you want to have a debate foreplay thing, and then let that be your foreplay cosplay. Thing. Like that could be your whole cosplay thing.
She wants to have a master debate.
Y'all could be on one debate team, and the other one could be on the other. I'm just gonna blow
that right shit exhausted
that.
Him.
I'm gonna get right through that. Yeah.
That exhausted.
We're just gonna
him.
Get right. Through
he
that.
Had has he's had a fucking enough.
Nigga said.
Tight enough.
Nigga said. Psst. So
he said shit.
It's coming from a nigga that was yelling roster card in the street, but we gonna get
that
past that.
Me.
Okay.
Not
let's
me.
React to this video. I'm gonna send you real quick, Lionel. All
right.
Check your.
I'm just gonna fuck myself.
Bro said, let's react to it.
No, this is actually from our folks.
Big folks and them.
On Fono. This is
on
from
Fonum.
This is from Tao and them.
Okay.
But this is his other one. I think it's So Shameless.
Okay. Oh, you sent it on the John.
Yeah, I don't know if you can hear it.
I'm
can
confused.
You hear it? Be playing something.
Come with a bunch a group of guys.
Can you hear it?
Mm-hmm.
Walk by, grab your ass, and start pressing you. Your man was right there. What would you want him to do? Your husband, by the way.
I want my husband to tell me, keep walking.
In that situation, that's protecting.
That's protection, yes.
The woman. Because if you turn it into a physical altercation, y'all are both
yeah, you risk both
up.
Of our lives.
So
I want
what
him
kind of protection is that?
Right. You got to think about the vision, not right now. That right now stuff, that's why men are in jail. I want my husband to say, keep walking. Unless somebody is physically assaulting me, I don't want to lose him. And I know he don't want to lose me either. That is his protection. That is his covering. And I feel like women a lot of time just don't look at the bigger picture because we want our husbands to do what our fathers should have done. Mm. That's
oh,
not
God.
His place. A lot of women want their husbands to prove to them that he's going to protect, that he's going to provide, that he's going to do all these things because their father dropped the ball. So. Go heal that with him. That's not your husband's place to do.
Yeah, no, we're not. So yeah,
you didn't want to listen to this before we played it,
huh?
You didn't want to listen to this before we played it here.
What was what? It what was being she just said don't walk away or walk away.
Did you not hear it?
Yeah, I heard something. I was like trying
and she
to...
said if a man grabs her ass,
oh,
what
oh
was
that
she
was
want
the
her husband
part.
Yes
oh I didn't
which
hear
does this. She want her husband to do. She said
walk
I want
away.
My husband to tell me to keep walking.
No,
not even close. And
I
shout
don't know.
Out,
I
shout
think
to
gonna,
shout out to our family,
I
So Shameless and Tyler.
Yeah,
but you
I'm
can't
gonna...
just grab my girl ass and I'm
and
just gonna
just
keep
walking.
Going.
Here, there's a difference. If I'm in the club, I've been in the club
clerb.
With someone.
Clerb.
I've been in the club
clerb.
With someone. Excuse me. And a nigga has like grabbed my hand or grabbed my arm or something. In that situation,
get off of her.
Yes, that is my woman.
Hey,
hey, don't
did
do
just,
that.
Did I just?
But
not
like,
nice.
In that
not nice.
You think my woman is a winch?
Wow. Sometimes.
Yeah, the
winch.
Fuck?
But like in that situation, yeah, like you can
that's
just do a simple
yeah.
like, chill, bro. And like, and then tell me like, go
she
ahead. But also you don't need to tell me to keep going because why would I be, I'm not going to turn around and be like, you rang? Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
I'm here with my nigga. However, if I am walking somewhere and someone grabs,
that's
got
what,
a handful
like
of my ass cheek.
About. Yeah.
Somebody grab a handful of my ass cheek. We gonna have to knuckle the fuck
yeah,
up.
Yeah, grabbing the ass.
Grabbing my ass. I don't have a small ass, so to grab my, you're like that's intentional.
Yeah.
I don't think I think that
I'm not saying you gotta shoot this nigga, but say
just,
something.
I think she's just saying that on the internet because
ain't no fucking thing. Way.
Because now niggas could just kind of walk up. Well,
what's wrong?
It froze on there. Is it still recording on?
Oh,
there?
Oh, we good.
Okay.
It was that means nigga it's free game. It's fair game now.
Oh, like cause she,
a nigga could just
yeah.
go grab your chick ass and you could and you.
Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to look at myself correctly that.
And
night.
I don't
like,
think
I
that
can't.
That's it's not about protection. I think it's a respect.
It's
thing.
Respect.
Yeah.
Respect me enough to
not touch
tell
me.
Someone not yeah
don't touch
like
me.
Not only tell them not to touch me like. say something to them for doing that. Because I'm gonna be looking at you crazy, like, no, I'll keep going. Because now we're not thinking about she didn't mention at all how I feel having had my ass grabbed by some stranger.
Yeah.
She totally glazed over that, right?
So I mean, like, as a man, I would feel weird. I wouldn't be able to
see what she do over it. She glazed.
People say that.
Glazed over is a little crazy.
But she also tried to bring in the point where
you want your husband to be a protector.
That's something you have to, that's something your dad's supposed to do. So
no,
your husband can't protect you because your dad failed to be a protector, or that's your dad's job.
I'm confused.
How is it your dad's job to be your protector when you are now married with a husband?
I mean, if I'm your guy, that's I'm supposed to be like, Mr. Johnson,
giving away at
Mr.
the
Johnson,
altar.
Let me tell you something.
He gave you away.
But I'm supposed to just go to him and be like, Mr. Johnson, this nigga at the club last night grabbed your daughter's ass.
Come get him.
We got to go find him. I got his license plate.
Right.
We could go get him right now.
Yeah. I told her to keep walking.
Yeah.
Her dad would be like, hey, what the fuck?
My dad would be like, what this nigga, I do understand
that people are crazy. There's a lot of crazy things that happen. Niggas die. Niggas have been dying at a crazy rate.
Which is that's why.
That's when you supposed to know how to look a crazy motherfucker in the eye and figure out if he crazy or not. That's when you start playing those games.
And also, I didn't say you got to punch him in the face, but the least you could do, a simple like, yo, bro.
Hey.
Or that.
Whoa, pow. That's her butt.
Yo, bro goes a long way between niggas.
That's her no-no parts.
Yo, bro, you good?
It's the way you say it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, yo, bro, what the fuck? Like,
that's where she poops out of, brother.
Okay.
What the fuck?
Got it.
You have the flash thing up and there's no flash on. Put it down.
It's broke.
That's making my shit go right now.
It's stuck.
You ever see some shit? You like, dog, why that's up?
What? That? It's just staring at you?
Yeah, I feel like it's recording me or something.
Also, the gun range need to take Arab people off the targets.
Arab people?
People with...
They have Arab people on their targets.
Yep, in the gun range in Pennsylvania.
Where did that? That's not what we were talking about at all. I hate the gun range.
Yeah.
I think
you got to stand up. I think you just got to say something. You should be able to say something.
Sometimes the internet make people try to get points off for
nothing.
For virality. And it's just I don't believe in that. I don't, because something in you as a nigga would spark to smack the shit out of a nigga that touched your girl ass.
If I love you, if this is the person who I want
to
be with
to be
for the
clear,
rest of my life.
Did they say it's... husband and wife?
Yes.
Okay.
He said my husband.
Okay.
And it's like, that's not a healing wound from your father.
No, not
at
all.
Not saying that your dad can't be a protector, especially when he around you. Nah, but you my girl, you my wife now.
My dad don't play that. He's very protective
that
and all
that's
that.
That's my ass.
Yeah, like, yeah,
but
like,
a real dad is going to respect, really wants to respect the nigga that his daughter is, you know, with.
Can't touch
so he's
wound.
Able to trust. Yo, this nigga gonna
if
make sure
happen,
my daughter
he gonna make
cool.
Sure she all right.
Yeah,
let's
so
touch that hole. Can't yeah. Do it. We share it.
All right, cool.
That's my Jesus hole God. Now. We both. That's our hole. That's not even her hole no more. Me and her.
Okay.
You try to grab my girl
let's
butt.
Just go past it.
That's connected to her butthole, and guess who butthole that is? That's our hole.
Ours. And it's connected to her coochie.
Our
to the rim of that coochie. She's a coochie rimmer. Question. Does this tickle?
Oh.
All right. Do you like to receive good news or bad news first?
I just be like, just tell me.
I want the bad first.
You think it matters?
I just want that out the way. Whatever. If somebody say they got news for me and they like, you know, good, whatever, whatever. Tell me the shit, the bullshit first.
Yeah.
Let's get to the happy part second.
I don't know. I think to argue the point, it might be good to have a nice little. Depends on like if it's really good news, you might want to hear that first to kind of even it out.
Okay.
Because imagine you get the bad news first, and that
and
really
it's terrible, and, it's super bad,
and it's really bad. So now you're like really bummer, and then they're like, "But I got ice cream." You're like,
"I do ask, like, how bad is it?"
Yeah, right. But I think I would like to hear the bad news. I would like to hear it maybe first. I don't know. Get it out the way.
First.
But I mean, you know, what if the good news is really good?
What if the bad news is huge and the good news is like a minuscule?
Just really. That's why you do it. That's why
just
you
just get out
of
the way
first.
How about they just say it at the same time? Two people come in.
All right. Yeah.
I'm about to text you the bad news.
And then I'm gonna say,
let me know when you get it.
And I'm gonna say,
I can say the good news.
Why are you reading this shit?
Yeah.
And they just like, guess what?
And also, your dog died.
You just got to prove for nobody to check out. It's like, oh shit.
Yeah.
Now I'm confused.
Okay. I have.
Did we talk about Diddy?
We did not talk about P Diddy.
Not talk about. What's his name?
Shout out to P Diddy.
Got it.
No shout out to P Diddy.
That's crazy.
Sorry.
P Diddy. Cassie is suing. Apparently, because now somebody said it wasn't real. Is it real?
Is it real?
Whatever.
Here's what I think we should start doing, which we will never ever do. It's been like this since the beginning of time.
Yeah.
I don't think we should blow anything up just yet.
Yeah.
Let's wait. Let's
play the waiting game.
That's how we got all up in that juicy smooth shit.
We just got an alert. And everybody started going crazy. I love the jokes. Don't get me wrong. Yeah. Twitter, it's unmatched. Always an event. I love it. But then you got like the serious think pieces. Once you read a serious think piece, you like, all right, let's do some research and wait and see what's going on. Let's just hold on real quick. Because y'all be so quick to just, pow, that nigga gay. Let's just wait for a minute. Like,
I think that Diddy woke up this morning and had a panic attack, because if my phone was going off like that, I would literally
absolutely.
Put my phone down.
I would go somewhere. Do you think he's used to it by now?
Like, not this shit.
It's different.
This is way different.
You see Russell Simmons, his ass went to fucking Zimbabwe, wherever you were, Bali, with his shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
nigga got the fuck going.
Yeah.
But here's the thing though.
He had to meditate.
Diddy is a nigga who fucks with younger women, right?
Yes.
Like, that's his vibe. And I do think that's a little weird. Because Diddy be...
Diddy be fiddling.
Young Fiddles Miami's about fiddling. 28, 29. Diddy like 54, 5. When he was younger, he was, you know, blah, blah, blah. But it's like, why is that the... You know what I'm saying? Cassie was 19. Diddy was like 34.
Yeah. Yeah, that's crazy.
So it's like... That's like, come on, man. Like, even if he ain't do nothing, it just gives like.
Lori Harvey.
What?
He was messing with Lori Harvey?
Did he?
What?
See, niggas is different. We weird.
That's the couple we need.
Yeah. Honestly. Did he and Lori Harvey?
Because wasn't Lori Harvey messing with his son?
True.
And then she was messing with him, and then she went to.
She don't play it. Michael B. Jordan.
She don't play. She gets down.
She gets down.
Lori Harvey gets down.
She does. She's
I know
the
her
bestest.
Coochie smell like
roses.
Sweet molasses.
Yeah, she take care of her shit for sure.
Yeah, she look like
we
she.
You can't say that, Samaj. Samaj just rolled her eyes. We can't say that. We can't say that she could possibly smell.
I mean,
good.
It's not what we were talking about.
To
go from something serious
P.
and talking
we
about the
talking
smell
about
of her fucking vagina, it's like, get the
topic.
Fuck real. But.
Lori Harvey definitely is top. But
he's always going to say something out of fucking pocket. So it's,
Yeah. I didn't know that Diddy dated Lori Harvey.
That's pretty cool.
That's interesting because she's only, what, now 26, 7? 20, how? She's like 27? She's like 26, 7-ish.
You just giving her an age.
Because she not over 30.
No.
Lori Harvey.
No.
So, but Diddy, I'm assuming when he dated her, he might have been like 47, 48.
Yeah.
So it's like, why he always walking?
Yeah, well, even me and you, we always say like, damn, it's an age that I can't even go below.
Fact though.
And my age at 29 is like 23, 24.
Yeah,
I can't
yeah.
go below 24.
She's
like,
26.
She's 26.
Jeez.
So she was like 20 when Diddy was fucking with her.
That was not 6 years ago, was it?
It had to be.
Whoa.
Because she was with... I don't know this shit. I don't know these little timelines.
But
what is a 19-year-old and a 37-year-old got to talk about?
Yeah. What the fuck are we even going to do?
Mm-hmm.
Cassie is what, our age?
Now?
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, just in general.
How old is Cassie? That's a great question, bro.
Cassie,
37? Oh, she's 37.
Was she 19?
Yes.
She was young as fuck when she came
out.
Yeah,
she was young.
And all that. They've been together for years.
Yeah. She was 19 and was trafficked, raped. Okay, what
she was 19.
Good Lord. Yeah.
Diddy? My God. Diddicus, come on, man.
Yeah, P. Diddy is Demetrius, going under. He going under that jail.
Pierre Diddyus, sure. Come on, man.
Sean, you's a bad motherfucker.
Watch your mouth.
Yeah, that ain't cool, man.
Do you think that...
My he deserves to be in jail? Absolutely.
No, I'm not talking about that.
Am I rushing to the...
No, you just said for us to wait.
Even though I just told everybody to chill, I just read some shit. They said she was sex trafficked.
Yeah, that's what her statement, John, said. But if we completely wrong, y'all, and this is fake news, we are sorry for the stupid. So
guess what? We said it. We need to do.
It checks out, though. Because they said... Who Junk Jock said this story about her shaving inside her head?
Yeah, he was like, they was watching a video and the girl, and then he was just like, yeah.
Go shave your head.
Go ahead, shave your head. And she was like, what Diddy wants, Diddy gets.
She ended up shaving her head?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Diddy seen a white girl do it, and he was like.
Young Jock being there is random, but not because he was supposed to be there at the time.
Very random.
But it's like, that's a random story.
Moment being, absolutely. It's going down, was definitely going down at that time. So
what's on?
It's going down. Meet me in the.
Oh, it's going down. Meet me in the. Meet me.
That is a hit record. Down.
That is a hit.
That's a hit.
Oh, let do it. That a hit too.
That's a hit.
All right.
Round of applause.
Baby, make that ass clap.
Hit.
You want to get in yours? I got serious like topics.
Ugh. Yeah.
I don't have serious topics.
Okay, getting pitis and ditis after sex. If those that don't know, after sex. Have you ever had sex and then you get real sleepy and then you get pussy-itis or you get dick-itis?
Shut the fuck up, bro. All right,
I'm going to go.
So, yeah, it's just like after you just got nigga. Some good-ass pussy, you get some pitis, some pussy-itis, and you just like,
why are you sure pussy-itis? The pitis.
Pitis?
Yeah.
You like pussy-itis?
Yeah, because you confuse me with pitis. I'm like,
pitis sounds like a disease. It sounds like some real shit, don't it?
It's like you got some.
Yeah.
You just got the pitis.
I did get some. I got my ass right to bed. That's what happened.
Okay, all right, brother. You scared me for a second.
Come on now. I got some shit.
Nah, pussy-itis is a real thing.
Yes.
That after sex, I got to go to bed.
I'm done.
It's a real thing. Niggas made up nigga-itis. Lana just made up pussy-itis.
And ditis. Or pitis. Don't forget ditis. That's dick-itis. That's dick-itis. Now, Samaj.
For sure.
Can you attest to that?
For sure.
Knocked out. Now, as the ditis giver, I done seen a couple of backs turn and just sleep on the bed. And they just...
And I mean back turn.
Knocked out.
Knocked the fuck out.
I'd be like, you want me to go get you a towel? They're done. They don't even respond.
Especially when you sleep.
Especially when you come inside of her. Whoa. Go right to bed. Uh-oh. That'd be the... Y'all ain't never did that?
Uh-oh. Yeah, I have. That's
yeah, just crazy. Go right
that's
to
crazy.
Because there's no cleanup. It's just...
It's got to be a cleanup.
You'll make a girl go
that's
pee.
That's so unsafe.
Because you think there's some real myth that works.
What?
Make a girl go pee. Pee your nut out.
No.
Because you think it works.
Like no, you're supposed to tell. They're supposed to pee after sex for.
For that reason. But my head be like, go ahead and sit on the toilet real quick.
Pee,
let it drop
pee
out.
Pee the cum out?
Yeah, but it don't work. It's not real. I know this.
Obviously.
Oh, but, my God.
Like, it's like eggs and stuff. Yeah, just, it's a whole bunch of like technical pick terms. Up. Go ahead and shake it out.
Let it drop. Let my shit drip out.
Yeah.
Why is this getting marinated in there?
This is the most disgusting conversation.
That don't
work.
That's disgusting?
Yes.
Shake it out.
Ew.
Get it out.
What did Marlon say on Sway Podcast that had them shut the room
twerk
down?
Twerk to come out.
Write down twerk to come out, please, for me.
If you tell a girl to shake it out, and she start twerking.
Yo, if you bust another shirt. Sure, hold on real quick. If
the look on this nigga's face when you said that.
If you bust a nut, shorty, and you tell a Turk to come out, it's fucking crazy. But now I'm about to try, yo. Get that, especially if she's not on BC. Go ahead and
she's
make it creative. Turk the nut out.
Turking to come out is disgusting. What are we 12? Like, what
she
the
be
fuck
like, yeah. I want to send five women with some twerking. Yeah, she's sick of that shit. Let it. That was good. That was so good.
If you get
that
done having sex, you just turn some twerk music on.
Yeah.
Shake something. Go on, shake something.
Do it, baby. Sticky, baby. Do it, baby. Yeah, lick right. It, baby. Suck up on it, baby. She said, suck up on his pussy till his pussy got a hickey, baby.
That's some real shit.
I ain't never suck on no pussy. Gave it
I
a hickey.
I want a slim fine woman with some twerk. Yeah.
Yo, go get to the City Girls albums.
Right
they
now.
Do so good. Because so.
They need it.
And I fuck with JT. Like, I want to fuck JT, so go ahead then.
All these niggas want to fuck JT.
They do.
This is going to make it work.
this.
Yeah, you telling everybody.
Yeah, go go get her listen to the album.
Yeah.
I'm getting her 7 sales.
Listen to my baby album.
Go ahead and tear.
A couple streams. Couple thou.
Okay, I got a question.
Yeah.
Realistically, in a world, yeah. Realistically, how many women do you think you can fuck in one day? You just had a day full of nothing, and you had access to, a bunch of women. How many do you think you physically can go fuck in one day?
Yeah, are we being honest?
Yeah.
Completely honest with thyself?
Yes.
Two.
Is this fucking to completion?
Nothing, yeah.
Two. My dick stopped working after, the third round, honestly. My shit just be like...
Yeah.
My shit don't... Brother...
I think I got 3 in the possible.
We're done here.
3 in the possible. But I would have to start fucking early in the morning. Take a break.
They're all getting one round?
Break.
Everybody's getting one round?
Yeah, they're getting one round.
Yeah.
They ain't giving out superior dick. We just giving out... We're not giving out... Yeah,
you're giving out mediocre dick.
Just be honest with yourself.
To the point,
You know how much energy that takes?
Yeah. But if I start at 9 a.m.,
you ever see that picture of the girl that was just cooking at Popeyes and she just got done making all them chicken sandwiches and she was sitting on a bench like this?
Oh, yes.
That's how I would feel after one.
Yeah.
That's how I feel after two. Two rounds. I'm like,
two fucking rounds, dummy. Yeah, I think I got 3 in the possible.
That's exactly what I say, too. Dumbass.
Remember you was...
Two, dummy.
Dang, I had a song I wanted to sing.
You was fucking, you was bugging,
It was
bugging that day.
It was, that was a long time ago. That was my heyday.
Yeah, you was bugging that day.
I was like.
I know you was bugging because you felt bad.
It was like one shorty that was like, one of them that was like, I'm on my period. And I was like, all right, that's fine. And she sucked my dick. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you was getting
She sucked my dick. And then that's when I met another one we had sex. Brother, this is a terrible story.
Keep telling me.
I'm saying it on Patreon.
No, say it now.
I'm saving it for the Patreon.
This nigga was on a fucking spree. He called me like...
What is wrong with me?
Called me like, yo, bro.
It was all like within the span of like a week.
30 hours. No, it was like 36 hours. I swear to God. It was like a day and a half.
Oh. Shut the fuck up. How about that? How about we play those games?
I'm sorry.
We don't know how.
I'm sorry. This nigga,
you be in a room full of shorties. Like this nigga be like, hey, bro.
Not Mr. Boop me in front. Not Mr. Boop. Not that. Don't you ever.
Did we talk about that?
No, we didn't.
You remember that?
At we the paint sip.
And we was in a room.
Puffin paint.
We was at the puffin paint. And I said, broop.
Yeah. Yo. Yes.
So I don't want to hear you say nothing that we talk about around your means.
We not yet, but you.
Yeah. That shit was so.
That was funny.
His reaction to the like, nigga.
That was fun. Was that
what the fuck was that?
That wasn't fun. That was
so.
Stupid.
And it was so funny.
We thought it was funny.
You like a fucking.
They
would have
thought it was funny too. A girl would not see that and be like. A girl wouldn't see that and be like.
Bitch.
How about you try that with
somebody losing me.
Try that with somebody else.
That's so funny.
Try that with somebody else. Don't do that to
they
me.
They loved it. They thought it was cute. Oh my God, that shit such was such a cute friendship.
They said that nigga's fucking. I said, yo, what the fuck? I felt a finger go rip on my
nose. I said, bro, you got something on your shirt.
Broop.
That kills, bro.
No, that don't kill.
Yeah, it killed us.
It's hilarious. That is so funny.
Y'all got a good laugh.
His reaction. No, but we usually get a good laugh at you.
Brother, it was funny, brother. That's good.
You see her?
You could bag a shorty with
you. You see her?
I just like falling out that chair.
You did what?
You falling out the chair.
Oh, that's so
it
long.
It took him 7 minutes to hit the floor. It was so quiet. We turned around. Did you just fall? No.
Let's forget about that, though. We passed that.
You did break the chair.
Bro. I did. We passed that.
Oh, God. That's going to be forever.
I was leaning on that thing.
No, I sat on that shit.
Why?
Oh, you just sat down and it just...
No, I sat though.
Nope. Yeah.
I ain't do a cute sit.
That was like at the end of the day sits. You ever sit down at the end of the day? You
just it took him forever to get to the floor.
Ain't take me that long.
Oh, yeah.
It's a fat joke. I don't like fat jokes.
You think everything I say is a fat joke?
Yeah, it's a fat joke.
No, it's just a joke and you just... All right, let's get out of
here. See?
No, just it's all
she right. She get her rocks off by
me. She called the group chat Big Beck.
So evil.
She called the group chat Big Beck.
That's so evil.
Called everybody Big Beck.
That's so evil.
And they was like, hey.
Some Becks are bigger than others.
They said, hey, no. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Whoa. Yes.
What chat?
Our group chat. She called everybody Big Beck.
In the Discord?
Yes.
Oh, shit. I ain't seen that. That's offensive to a couple other people in there, too.
What? No.
A couple.
Hey, Kay, the mic is up.
Yeah, it is. Uh-oh. There's a couple people in there. Big Beck. It's me. Me and Larry. We the only two Big Beck motherfuckers in there. Everybody got skinny backs. Little Beck.
I wanna do my gym of the week and get out. Chill, bro.
Ain't no fucking chill, bro. I'm a thief.
Chill, bro.
Take it from right up under you.
What the fuck?
Talking about taking from some eyes.
Can you?
That still sound crazy. Hold on.
You go ahead and
pause, nigga.
Yeah.
I had Benzino fingers on here, but that's not fun.
He just needs to drink water. He's dehydrated.
I think he passed that point.
Oh, you think it's over for that? He got them stupid Jones. Yeah, brother, what? Take care of yourself. That's why he over here talking about something. Is it wrong if I ask for like if you yes. know whatever she has, da da da. It's yes. like brother, you're not
also,
making any money right
from
now.
From what she talks about, which they keep fighting against, is she said he wasn't even that fucking active.
He probably wasn't.
That's what I'm saying. So like why he think that he could just be like
$5,000? That brother is.
That's the trials of an ancient dad who want to come back around. They like
me for real.
But First of all, that's another loving hip hop nigga. That whole time he was on there, nobody knew he had fucking kids.
How about that?
How the fuck?
That's why when it came out, I was like, why would y'all lie and say that was her dad? I had to look the shit up, and I was like, motherfucker, you was on the show for too long for us not to know you
had kids. Yeah,
that's bad. That's See? So bad, brother.
But then you want to come back around right now.
That nigga ain't shit.
He said, I made you. Yeah, you provided a sperm.
Brother, you, yeah.
It's called a donor, yeah.
Technical, yeah. You did make her.
But why would you? I don't know. How much money do you think he asked Coil Ray for? $5,000?
It's a couple thousand. It's probably up there.
What if he asked for $100?
I would say like something close to $100.
Thousand?
That's crazy.
That's crazy.
Y'all think that's crazy?
Yeah, for her, yes.
She got money, though.
Not $100,000 to give away. Not $100,000 for a nigga to ask for.
Like, that's probably why he making such a big fuss about it.
He's loud. Like, shake it through your waist down. Shake it.
That nigga probably asked for $10,000.
No.
I'm not giving that nigga
$10,000. I don't think anything in rich nigga land is $10,000.
But I don't think these niggas is that rich, though. I really don't.
I don't either.
Yeah, like.
I think they buy a chain rich.
Yeah.
Coi Leray. How much?
Oh, she's not that rich.
You don't think Coi Leray is rich?
She cool.
Let's look at the Googs.
Google it.
Her net worth.
Racially ambiguous.
Oh, the Andre 3000 Flu album.
I'm not really getting this. Yes. It's an album.
Andre 3000 released the album full of him playing flutes, and I'm going to listen to it.
Yeah, I'm going to listen to
and
it.
And I'm
too.
Not mad about it. I don't think Andre 3000 owes us anything. I think he did a great job.
At being a legend?
At being. And he kept it a bean. He said, I don't have nothing to rap about. You watched the interview with GQ?
I did. I watched
Wealthy Gorilla, she would amass a net worth of $3 million.
Yeah, but that's like that don't mean you got that liquid like this money.
Yeah, that's not that doesn't mean that it's yeah. there. But also like him asking for $100 is not
that's crazy.
Crazy.
Okay. The Flute album.
Yes.
Andre 3000 said he has nothing to rap about. And I respect
and,
it.
If a nigga don't got nothing to rap about, I don't like going on the internet and then seeing people go like, but bro, like you don't got nothing to rap about. Like, no, nigga, yeah. you don't got nothing to rap about.
Right.
Rap for him then.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Niggas like, trying to force it out of.
Pause, nigga.
Niggas trying to force. I knew
Why
you I knew,
look at me?
Because I knew he was ready for that. Niggas trying to force it out of him.
Yeah.
And he don't want to rap.
He
and then
when
old niggas rap and it's corny, which he wouldn't put out a corny album. But when an old nigga rap and he forcing it, now y'all like y'all did with 444.
They be like, yo, this trash. It'd be like, brother, you're asking for it.
You're asking
for this person to rap.
444 wasn't trash.
They said it was good.
But a lot of people are like, why are you rapping about da da da?
Why is he rapping about being older and buying property?
Yeah.
Shoot a nigga in your music. Why aren't you talking about killing people? Why aren't you talking about heartbreak?
Because he's a grown-ass man. Yeah. He's an adult.
I still did Chance.
He knows who the fuck he wants to date.
Chance came out and said,
Chance too young
I love
for
my
that.
Life.
No, Chance was too young
my
for
wife,
that.
I love the Lord.
He did that at 25, 26. Yeah.
He did it when it was
they
like...
They said, tomatoes, tomatoes. Right. Yeah. Yeah. We throwing like, tomatoes at you.
It was like, all right, brother.
He tried to speed up his career. He was like... He supposed to do that at 40. You can't do that now.
He's supposed to do that at like 30, 37, 35. He's supposed to be like, yeah, I settled down. I love the person that I'm with. Cool. You're like 25. What are you talking about?
They said...
But I think people that are like, even if you do put out like a flute album, like I get it, but you know what we want. It's like, brother, you're dick eating at this point.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up and take the music.
That's not what he want.
Also, instrumentals are kind of cool.
Yeah.
I like instrumentals. They're kind of like, chill out. It depends on what the vibe is. Like,
it's sorry.
It's a vibe. Did we talk about her and Toni Braxton?
Tamar Braxton. I had that on my list of topics. She pulled a little mama.
Krishan.
And then she laid hands on somebody on her
singers. Team. Yeah, that's she's disgusting.
Somebody said she walked up and grabbed the mic. Nobody's more legendary than Lil Mama's though.
From all the way out here, it's hilarious. From like being a little bit closer in, that's insane.
Lil Mama said they said Lil Mama walked past Beyonce and was like, "No, we got to do this. This got to happen."
Especially because Beyonce grabbed her and she like pulled her arm away.
Yeah,
I'm
Beyonce,
like, bitch.
She was like, I gotta
she
make it happen.
She literally, grabbed her. And then she even like was like, Lil Mom, like, what is you doing?
Larry had one of, that's exactly why you're supposed to close it out, nigga. You stupid nigga.
Motherfucker.
I hate this nigga talking about something. No, I just lowered a tent.
No, like that contributes to sound.
Oh, I just turn it down. No, turn it off.
That dumb bitch was standing. She said,
Beyonce couldn't even like.
She didn't have time.
Beyonce can't be like, no, seriously, don't do it. Yeah, like you can't even. Her going like this.
Her,
to Jay-Z. And Jay-Z just got to nod back. You got to.
But also the look on his face, like he looks at her like,
bitch. What's she doing up here? Yeah. There's nothing you can do.
That's some New York ass shit. She felt that in her spirit.
She did.
She said,
you know what? This is the concrete jungle.
Yeah.
What did Krishan feel in her spirit when she was twerking on stage?
So she was supposed to come out and perform the It's a Vibe All the Time shit.
Who said that?
Tamar.
Oh.
Tamar, she put a live, she put a live video out and said each town that she's going to, which is true, she has asked someone to like do an opening. She asked Drew Sidora. She asked Candace Dillard when she went to D.C.
Sanders?
Drew Sidora.
That's crazy for
Irrelevant.
Shador Sanders.
I thought it was Shador. Okay, I thought it was Shador Sanders.
And so when she was going to Baltimore,
okay,
she asked Krishan, it'd be cute if you come out and, you know, perform your song and then, you know, like go back to your seat. She says she did not ask her officially. She said there was no contract or anything like that because she knew Tony was coming out to sing during her show. So she didn't need an opener. She didn't need anything because she has fucking Toni Braxton coming.
Yeah, that's your,
And apparently Krishan got up there and.
So wait, so she thought she was going to be performing It's a Vibe.
I guess so. I guess she
and then
thought
it was
she was
like, yo, last minute.
But then while Tamar
one of the
is performing,
singers in the world is going to actually come.
But while and Tamar perform, was actually performing her song, Krishan like
she said, fuck
gets
that.
Up on stage and she's up
she
there.
She started twerking, right?
With her fucking
she was throwing
gap.
Ass in front of her, right?
She was like doing a little two-step and some shit. I said, Lord,
yeah, that's
look at this
cool.
shit.
I don't
and
know
then somehow,
this. Krishan got her own song going on.
It's a vibe all the time.
I take it for a ride. I just want to.
Ain't that
Jaden
Smith? J-Lo Smith?
Yeah. Actually, you're right. It is. Silly me.
What the fuck is Sean be singing?
It's a vibe all the time. God damn it.
Brother, I don't know the fuck is Sean.
It ain't good words.
It's
you,
not a
do
hit.
You understand what she said?
I'm trying
it's
to understand what the fuck y'all talking about. Because I'm like, what the fuck
we,
was she
we talking about her song?
She not performing. She not singing, I'm a bad little bitch and I'm shaped
like
a Barbie.
Barbie.
Hips, lips, ass in a Cardi. Hello, motherfucker. Hello, motherfucker. Now, that shit would have went crazy. I don't know what the fuck her song be saying.
Why ain't give her that? Why she singing a rock song?
That's not her song, bro.
That's what I'm saying, though.
He said, what did they just play that
Blueface could have gave her that, though. Like, why he give her? He gave it to the weird looking one.
Chill.
All right, my fault.
Why am I saying chill?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't
that's
know.
You. That's you.
I don't know.
Bro said chill.
Not black. Right. I'm not defending no non-black woman.
Yeah. Shout out to Krishan Rock. No shout out to her, actually. Shout out to Tamar, because she handled it correctly.
I do think this is the last topic, because we're running out of time. I think that people appreciate Well, I'm going to speak on dating, you know, women and shit. I do think that women and people you date and appreciate thoughtfulness over money, but there has to be a balance of the thoughtfulness. Mm-hmm. You know, it can't be like we in the crib or we going to the park, but I do think that thoughtfulness plays a long part and a long role in letting somebody know that you care about them, especially when they have special holidays or birthdays or things like that. It could be small shit, you know what I'm saying? That goes... Cause that means you listen.
Yes.
You're not just, you mean you're not just around. You hear shit. You listen. You
and
observe.
Here's a pro tip for not just the gentleman, but everybody out there. Right. Whenever you hear the person that you're talking to, if you really care about this person, if you really like want to do something good for them, if they're around and they say something that they either want or that they want to do, go ahead, pull your notes out real quick.
Right in the contact.
Write it down.
In the context.
Write it down. I'm telling you, it goes a long way because at some point you could just pop out. And even just the thought of you saying something like, oh, I remember you said that you wanted to do this. I looked into it. They just want to hear that you looked into it. Even if you say, yo, I looked into it, we could do it next weekend, or they don't have it here, so maybe we should try to find something that's close to it.
Right.
They'll be like, damn, this person is thoughtful, da-da-da. And then you go like, you know, they don't got no glass blowing classes in the city, but I did find like a pottery joint, and then you just boom, you go that way, you take it from there. It's all thoughtful, it's all from the heart. You know, it meant something to the person that you that gave, you know, you the idea, you correct. Gave them the whatever. It's all, it's a win-win. You're gonna get some good pussy after that.
Everything's not about getting the good pussy after
shut
that.
Up okay. coming
it's
from
about,
you brother
it's about
shut up
it's about getting good
shut
good
up.
Knowledge
No.
And letting somebody know that you love them. It's not always about pussy.
Are you insane?
Like, come on.
Have you lost your mind?
It's not always about women.
At the end
women.
Of the day, you got a poise on.
To poise.
You said that again?
You remember, you got a poise
in. You got a poise in.
You might have been a poor.
You might have been a poor son.
Poor son.
Who the fuck said that again? Gilly?
No.
Cam?
No. Listen to Swiss Beats, right?
Thank you,
yes. Oh, yes. In a very serious tone.
Yeah, he was talking to whatchamacallit, and whatchamacallit and Drink Champs was like, shut the
that's
fuck up.
That's what happens when niggas with money talk. You just be like, all right.
All right.
I don't give a fuck what Swiss Beats say. I'm rocking.
Yeah.
Yo, we finna roll up out of here. We ain't got no time left on the clizz.
He said, he fucking that hoe. She fucking
that
my
bitch.
Dick. She's sucking my heart.
She's sucking my dick.
You
giving us
back.
You giving us
back.
And then when I'm in the I bought you a bag. Yo.
Uh-oh.
Philly.
Bad little bitch then.
We never coming back
and
to
I'm
do a show.
Like a party. Bips, hips, lips, dips, clips.
I learned the hip stances like this one. You got to cup your hands. Yeah, like that. That makes it look better.
That's what makes it hip hop.
Yep. All right.
That's
hey,
what
my
makes
gym,
it hip hop.
You.
Oh, wait. I brought it back. Turn it up.
It's been up.
Oh, turn it up.
Hey, my gym of the week is.
That's what he said, right?
Go buy yourself something new this week. Go get you a piece of clothes. Go get you that snack you like. Take care of yourself this week.
Yeah. Do it.
Got it.
Do it. Hey,
yo.
Oh, well, I was. Damn. Damn, nigga.
Bit. Oh. It looked like you wanted
no.
to say bitch,
no,
so
no,
I was trying
no,
to
no,
say
no,
no,
I was.
No,
yeah,
no,
that's
no,
crazy.
You got it.
All right. My gym of the week is. Oh, I got a perfect one. If you wanna buy a gift for her child, make sure it's something that you can do too, because
we
are
both
selfish.
Benefit. Absolutely.
We are selfish people. Cause absolutely. If I tell her like, yeah, you know what? I think I'm gonna get your child a PlayStation 5.
That's a
it's
big
so
one.
I can play.
Keep it there.
Straight like
you
that.
You know what? Who else gonna play it?
Me.
Me, nigga.
That's our PS5.
I'm sorry. I am gonna get the gift though. I'm gonna get the gift. I've got it.
Hey, yo.
Bitter.
It's motherfucking.
Don't let him touch
late
you.
Late night.
With.
Mother.
Fucking.
Lur.
No. We got this bitch.
This is why they think. This is why they think.